Oh my God. Hello, hello. One sec. Pour my beer. Is he complaining about Mob Crush again? Every time. Every time about Mob Crush. Now if I go here, I think. Yep. Fantastic. Perfect. Oh, there we go. What are we drinking today? Dry hopped farmhouse ale, Northeast Brewers Showcase. I gotta say, this is quite good. Hi, Howler. Welcome, my dude. Welcome, welcome. Smoking toilet. And hey, welcome, welcome. Hope everybody's doing all right today. You're my biggest fan, smoking toilet. Are you? Wow. Thank you. That's very kind. Phil, hello. Welcome to the chat. Just giving everybody a moment or two before we jump into anything. This gives me a minute or two to enjoy a little bit of my beer. Saturday, I'm allowed to, damn it. Have we seen Analog Horror? I mean, you know I have. Hi, Howler. Banana Man, we're back on this channel for these watches, man. You made a good point. Made a good point. It makes sense. It makes sense. So we're jumping into a little bit of Meat Canyon today because I was told last week to check it out. So that's what we're gonna do today. I've seen maybe Edgar.DTC20 subscribe. Thank you, Edgar. Thank you. Very kind. What happened to Weird Birds? Well, I mean nothing's happened to it. It's still ongoing. I just bring you the stories, but I didn't create it. It's still ongoing. Still ongoing. He just hasn't released any of the other parts yet. But I'll keep you guys posted, don't you worry. 8-Bit Ryan did react to the Vita Carnis Analog Horror. Oh, okay. I mean, Vita Carnis is just it's just awesome anyway. Like it's such a well fleshed out Analog Horror. I think it's probably one of the best things about it is that there's so much effort, time, and like dedication that went into it. So good. So very, very good. Awesome. Looks like chat's working on there. That's happy days. So I've seen a couple of little, like, I mean, short videos from Meat Canyon. I haven't seen anything long. I don't know. Oh, I guess they do long ones as well. I don't really know where to jump in, if I'm honest with you. We check out Nuke's Top 5. I love Nuke's Top 5. We can absolutely watch one of their videos at one point. Bizarrebub. Haven't seen Bizarrebub. But Nuke's Top 5, I mean, he's even in my subscription somewhere. I think, or am I on I'm on the wrong account right now. Yeah, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what account I'm on. Even the Doors Analog Horror? The Doors Analog Horror? What's. I don't think I don't know if I know that one. I'll have to look into that. Need to react to Slap Tam. I like Callum. I like Slap Tam. I think he's just a little bit too calm when he talks in the videos. That's the only thing that kind of gets me with Slap Tam. Otherwise, you know, I think he's a great guy and I love the fact he covers creepy content as well. It's just awesome. I do enjoy him. I don't watch him as much as like Nukes, for example. Because Nukes is just like, you know, it's a little easier to digest. Is there like a playlist or shorts? Yeah, I feel like I've seen some of their short stuff. I really do not know where to parody stuff, maybe. I feel like I need somebody to guide me because I don't really know where to jump in from here. You got your new setup, Banana Man. Proud of you. Proud of you, man. You worked for it. Proud of you. Good shit. I'm going to. Oh, you know what? They got a big animation one here. What's this? Is this like everything? Everything? Maybe. Looks like it covers a bunch of things. Okay. Well, this will be maybe how we start. Maybe not. 7 years ago. Is that a little too far back? I don't know. Maybe we'll jump a little further in. Beer fairies and AA. You know what? That sounds kind of funny. Maybe we'll start there. Day drinking.
Hi, I'm Bruce. Welcome back to Day Drinking. Don't mind me. I've had a couple. Got a little buzz going, but, you know, that's just a day drinking fashion. But last Wednesday, I asked you all to give me questions.
Feels very Trailer Park Boys.
Question one, and probably the biggest one that I've gotten the entire time is, Bruce, what's your favorite beer? Bruce, beer this. Bruce, beer that. Listen here. I don't drink beer. One. Why would I drink beer if it's just going to fill me up and make me want to drink less? Put me in a goddamn catnap, so all right?
Was he day drinking?
This is what I do. I get store brand cola. I drink half of it. Then I get bottom shelf whiskey. Now I'm talking about $8 to $12 whiskey. You pour that in there. That so can sad. Is so versatile, but it can go I've wherever you want it to be.
Well,
I don't condone drinking
everywhere.
And driving, but I'm saying it's an option. Your opinion on furries. Well, I don't know if this is the same thing, but I used to have a Furby back when I was a kid, and I tell you what, that shit scared the living hell out of me. Just be up at night looking at you.
Thinking of Furbies. Wake up,
have a wet dream. All of a sudden, your nights ruined because a goddamn Furby sitting there looking at you. No, thank you.
What?
Next question. What? Have you ever been court-ordered to attend an AA meeting? Yeah. I got drunk at a state park one time going to my nephew's baseball game when he played for the Gladstone Lynxes.
I mean, this is fine. It's not what I remember of Meat Canyon. Maybe let's try. They must have scarier. I know they do. The Willy Wonka one. Hang on, where's that one? Because that's funny, creepy. Here we go. This is the one that I remember.
Well, Charlie, funny, creepy. You're the last child left. Isn't that exciting?
I don't know.
You're a very lucky little boy.
Furbies
are
scary.
You get to see what's behind that door. Now, Charlie, don't you want to see what's behind that door?
Welcome, my dude.
I don't know.
Come on, it'll be fun.
Strawberry Shortcake,
follow
thank
me.
You for subscribing. McFace Gaming, welcome, my dude.
Huh, caught you taking a peek there, Charlie.
It's so weird. It's so funny.
That's all right. Nothing wrong with window shopping from time to time. It's when you get handsy. It's when you get yourself into some trouble.
Come over here, Charlie. There's one last part of the factory I'd like to show you.
That's okay.
Go ahead and taste the wall. Go on, try it. Well, what flavor do you think it is?
I don't know.
Charlie, I'm just messing with you. There's no flavor on the wall. You like that rust pretty good, though. Don't worry. We'll get you a little tetanus shot before you leave.
Where's my grandpa?
Oh, he's just hanging around. Don't worry. You're in good hands.
It's so creepy. And there he is, just counting up the money.
Take a look at this. Yeah, it's pretty cool. I know a lot of celebrities, I guess. You like their finger around here in the factory from time to time. And do you know who this is, Charlie?
I don't know.
That's the 42nd president of the United States, Bill Clinton. Yeah, he's a good friend of mine. Past presidents have a lot of connections, Charlie. A lot of connections. But so do I.
So.
You know, Charlie, your clothes look awfully filthy. I'm all for a little stink, but best to get you some clean clothes. You know, for later.
Oompa Loompa Doopa Dee Doo. You are a filthy boy, yes, that's true.
You have soft hands and beautiful eyes.
Take his measurements and be gone with you.
He looks like a medium. Let's get him a small. Get it right. Get it tight.
Be gone! Sorry about that, Charlie. That didn't make you feel uncomfortable, did it?
Yes. I don't know.
This whole thing is uncomfortable.
Gosh, Charlie, I gotta tell you, my back and shoulders are tight. Running a factory sure does have its physical costs. Have you ever had a massage, Charlie?
I don't know.
Your hands look very soft. Also strong, very strong. You play much baseball?
I don't know.
Only a couple rooms down. Come on, big guy. Charlie, you wouldn't mind giving me a quick massage, would you, pal? I hate to be a stickler about the rules, but the golden ticket you have there states that I can ask for a free massage at any time. You look like you don't believe me. Go ahead and take a look. We've really bonded, Charlie. I'm excited to get to know you a whole lot better.
It's strange. It's great.
Charlie, let's put those hands to good use. What do you say?
There he is!
You didn't see anything. You hear me, you little shit? You didn't see a fucking thing.
We didn't know what was going on here! We didn't know a fucking thing!
Don't worry, son. You're safe now. He didn't hurt you, did he?
I don't know.
Charlie, my friend! I made it out of the Chocolate River, Charlie! Charlie!
Oh, Jesus Christ! He's got a gun!
It was just some German kid.
Damn! Chocolate monsters, yeah! That's it!
Chocolate monsters.
We don't want to tell anyone about what happened here today with the chocolate monsters. Right, Charlie?
I don't know.
Get him out of here!
Oh, okay. We've been warned, okay? We've been warned, headphone warning. I don't know.
There was a house on top of a hill where a dying scientist bequeathed his life's work to his two assistants, Caps and Uno. The scientist gave instructions on how to create monsters to solve any problem, along with a series of documents on the cure to cancer, AIDS, and world hunger. But, unfortunately, due to an untimely grease fire caused by someone cooking surprise, not naming any names, but the house was burnt down, and the scientist's work was lost with it. Now!
What the fuck? What is going on? Oh my god. I don't even know. Some of these get real. Oh, okay. The secret, that looks creepy. So secret formula, we'll probably watch that. That looks creepy. Oh my god. Sorry guys, yeah. Oh, it's Kaiju Player. Welcome to the chat, my dude. Welcome, welcome. McFace Gaming, Strawberry Shortcake. Thank you, everybody. Xversity. Got all kinds of good stuff going on. This is great. It's great. This is Meat Canyon. Yes. Last week I was told to watch it. So that's what we're doing. At the current moment, we'll watch some Meat Canyon. We might move on from there to kind of watch other things that we all agree on, you know? It's a democracy. We all have a choice here. Especially if we get fed up with Meat Canyon. But that was pretty funny. I remember the Willy Wonka one personally. That's what I remember from Meat Canyon, which I thought was like just so creepy weird. So we're going to watch Secret Formula because that looks kind of creepy weird too.
Another beautiful day at the Krusty Krab.
Oh, God.
Another day.
That's
servicing
horrifying.
The masses.
Oh, SpongeBob. They can't get enough. They want more.
Yeah, this is some nightmare fuel right here.
More of that. Secret formula. That smells good. Good.
This is so...
Doesn't it, Mr. Krabs?
Aye. It do, Mr. Squidward.
It's just a different kind of horror, right? It's just...
Sponge me, boy.
Creepy body kind of
maybe
shit.
Maybe a bit more of that. Secret formula.
so fucking weird.
Is that good, Mr. Krabs? Is that how you like it?
Aye. That's how old Mr. Krabs wants it, but the salty dog wants even more. Can you feel that?
Oh, God. I can feel it, Mr. Krabs.
What Mr. Krabs fuck is dipping his hand in the old honey jar, isn't he?
You can take as much as you want, Mr. Krabs.
No, don't leave me out. I need you, SpongeBob.
Go on and get yourself a handful.
The
secret formula.
This is just God, so, it's so unpleasant.
Fucking good.
Flavor.
Take
I need more flavor.
Take it off.
This is just.
Take all of the secret formula.
This is just a different kind of creepy.
Take all of the secret formula. Was that good for you? Did I satisfy you all?
No. No.
You did, me boy.
No.
But.
No.
You're all used up. Drained, me lad.
Our hunger is satiated for now. But we'll be back.
I love my job at the Krusty Krab. I wouldn't change it for anything in the whole world. I make people happy. I fulfill their needs.
This is
frankly,
just...
I don't think I could stop even if I wanted to.
Jesus Christ.
But who would want to stop? When people love what you do this much.
Okay. Well, I'll be honest with you. I didn't see that coming. It was... uncomfortable and unsettling and downright bizarre, if I'm 100% honest with you. Okay, I'm glad we're all on the same page. Yeah, that was strange. Should we continue to give ourselves nightmares? Lasagna, oh, that looks fun. Who doesn't love a bit of Garfield uncomfortable horror? Why not?
Hey, Liz!
Hey, John! You ready for the movie?
Yeah, I've been looking forward to the movies all week. One second. I just need a couple of minutes to get some stuff sorted out inside with the animals before I leave. Garfield, would you come in here for a moment?
Meow. 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 Meow.
Can you tell me why you decided to get into the lasagna again?
Oh, no.
Tell me why you thought that would be okay!
Meow. I'm sorry, John. I'm sorry.
Why are you speaking to me, cat? Cats can't speak, can they? Can they?
Meow.
Good! Now make bread! Make bread like a good cat!
Oh, God.
Go on! Be my little baking boy! Yeah! Yeah, there he is! Something smells good in here!
Baked goods!
Hey, what's up?
Everything going okay in there? I heard some shouting about a bakery or something.
Oh, yeah, no. I just ruined a batch of bread I was working on. I'll only be a second longer.
Homemade bread? That sounds good. Please, take your time.
Oh, he probably will.
Oh, Garfield, she's so nice. I can't believe it. Me, John Arbuckle, in love. Who would have thought?
Oh.
I don't know, I got a good feeling about her.
This is...
Like she wouldn't judge me or... Like she would just accept me for who I am.
This is horrifying.
She wouldn't be such a pain to train like you, Garfield. Always putting up a fight.
Just outrageous.
I'm glad those times are over. I'm just looking for a lady, Garfield. Someone who will stand by my side, but but they're also stupid! They peck away at my mind! They always make things so difficult! I wonder if she wants a small wedding. She better not want some big fucking wedding! That bitch! That fucking whore! All they think about is money. All they want is money, money, money! I'm sure of it. I'm sure she wants a small wedding. I'm positive. Not only a wedding, but I wonder if she wants a big family. Oh, I hope she wants a big family. God, I would love a big family. Somebody to love.
I love how in this John is the mad one.
Stop looking at me!
I already fed you. How much more can I give you? God damn it.
I don't know, Garfield. I think she's the one. I really do. God, the future is looking bright. Behave yourself. Hey, sorry about that. Let's go.
I better not fill up on popcorn. That lasagna you were talking about sounded good.
I like how usually in like Garfield horror stuff, it's usually Garfield is the horrific entity. But in this one, it's John. John is the messed up man. I thought that was a nice little twist. Hilarious. Oh, well, Banana Man says DaBaby. So I guess we'll check this.
watch. He turns into the car. Because you know the lyrics of the song.
Yeah, I don't know who that is.
Oh, well, he's a rapper. I pull up. Whoa! It's DaBaby! Bro, I was just showing my girl memes about you. Let's go. Let's go. Hey, what are you doing, man?
Jeremy, stop him!
Hey, get off my girl! Don't touch her, bro! Let's go. DaBaby's, they're everywhere. I pull up.
Don't touch me!
Get off me, man!
Okay.
Let's go.
Jeremy, no! Don't hurt him!
Let's go!
Comes up with this weird shit. I guess that's how it infects other people.
Let's go! Let's go! Let's go. I pull up! Let's go! Hey, I pull up!
I don't know what we're watching. It's so fucking out there. I am not drunk enough for this. Even if I were drunk, I don't think I would want to keep it. I wouldn't want to keep watching. This is so strange. It's just all... Yo-Kai Bob the Builder. Where he's like a spirit. What? How's this guy come up with all this strangeness, man? Oh, no. I don't know what's going on. I feel like I'm losing my marbles. Oh, God. How does he not? What a great question. Okay, here's one I think I've seen before. Five Nights at Markiplier's. There you go.
Hello? I just wanted to leave you a message letting you know a little more about the job. Now, you've been hired to watch over Markiplier's house? Yeah, he's a big-time YouTuber guy.
I completely agree with you. How did we go from where we were at to this?
Now, he's not like other game YouTuber types like your
This is what happens when I listen to everybody.
No, he loves milk. And frankly, I'll tell you
we might move on to an analog horror. So, I think I need something
I left
something
about three
different.
Gallons of whole milk in the basement, or was it two? I don't know. There should be enough to keep him satisfied for the night, or at least I hope. But if he runs out of milk, he gets, well, we don't need to go into all that, so be careful for all, you know. Also,
at least it made him look really
his house is
troll,
ran on
right?
milk energy, so you only have so much power for the night. But you should be
this
okay.
This makes him look really strong.
Just keep checking the cameras and only close the doors if absolutely necessary.
Hello, everybody. I'm Markiplier. Oh, God. Oh, I can smell your bones from here.
What the fuck's going on?
Sweet, sweet calcium.
That's creepy.
I need more calcium.
I don't know what's going on. Why do I agree to watch everything that people tell me to?
It's so hard making history every day. God, I'm so sexy. Oh, the milkman's being shy in his room. Oh, you silly cow. You have all the milk, don't you? Oh, it's so hard being me. The crowds scream, and they scream for me. Glory comes at such a heavy price.
Well, at least at the end it got creepy. Creepy weird. Yeah, let's jump into something else. I think I'm done with meat canning. That got way too off the rails, man. You say Bizarre Bub, okay. You know what? I'll take anything at this moment. I'll take anything different. Okay. Scary Compilation version 88. Let's do it. Jump straight into one. Happy
on October 10th of 2023, a toy camera captures footage of a girl playing with her toys and talking about her day. The entire video is nothing more than just a miniature vlog, as all she does is talk about her day and what she plans on doing with her friends in the following week. But there's something about this video that has left the girl's family deeply unsettled.
We're messing around with my little sister's camera.
It's weird.
It's weird.
Okay, I'm just gonna show it to you. Okay.
It goes without saying, but the video is pretty creepy. The following is the full video from the toy camera, posted by the older sister. Take a look.
Wait, she has Skibbity Toys one? Is she really?
Hey guys, today I'm going to show you my Skibbity toilet collection.
Oh my god, it is.
Got today. We went to a toy store and they had all of these things, like this cameraman, these tiny little action figures, this big Skibbity toilet, and these ones. And then we actually found these Skibbity toilet shoes, and they say Skibbity toilet on them. And I'm gonna wear it to school tomorrow.
Could somebody tell me, like, what the, I mean, I still don't understand Skibbity Toilet. I saw maybe, like, the first thing of it, and I was, like, so confused. I also don't see why people enjoy it. I don't know. I have no, maybe I didn't give it enough time. Maybe that's it. Asking the wrong guy? Yeah, that's fair. That's totally fair. Look, I mean, I get people like stuff. There's no problem with that. I just didn't understand it, you know. Some Gen Alpha crap. You'll never understand. Yeah, that's kind of how I feel, you know? Like I feel like I'm willing to give things a chance. But, you know, I mean, I don't want to say I'm getting too old for certain things. I don't want to think that way, but there is certainly a lot of things that younger people enjoy that I don't understand. You know, so I guess that does make me feel kind of older. Skibbity sucks. Okay, I'm glad I'm not the only one who thinks kind of it's the Icon Has Cheeseburger, the Zoomer generation. Okay. Yeah, just that's fair. I think it's always just a generational gap thing, isn't it? Because, I mean, even YouTube, like, really leaned into advertising about Skibbity Toilet, and I just did not understand. Even you, as Gen Alpha, you don't understand Skibbity Toilet. You know, I really appreciate that, guys. Okay. I mean, I understand why people buy merchandise of things they like, so I'm not arguing that point. It's just, I never understood Skibbity Toilet. So I'm just glad that we're all on the same page here. That's awesome. That's really good. Like, stop giving every child a Funder tablet, dude. Tell me about it. When they hit a certain age, fair enough. Not when they're too young, you know?
A lot of kids at my school like Skinny Toilet.
Also, she's very quiet. I can't believe they have toys for that.
So my friend the other day, and we went on a walk, and we also got ice cream that day, and I'm having a lot of...
going on, little girl? You want to show us? Because we can't hear a damn thing. She's freaked out by something. She's freaked out by something. But what? Did we get... Oh, hang on. See anything, maybe? Oh, okay. That's interesting.
What starts off as an innocent video turns into something completely different. Midway through the footage, something catches her attention, but after seeing whatever it was, she's immediately put on edge. It's as if she was paralyzed with fear, but thankfully, she was able to leave before things got a whole lot creepy. Only a few minutes later, we see this. A dark figure passes in front of the tent. It's hard to make out what this was, but her older sister is certain that this is what her sibling had seen. Now, it's unknown if she's asked her about what she saw, as the only information on this video is the context she gave. But until there's an update, we won't know for sure what was there.
Yeah,
so
fair,
until
fair.
Then, you be the judge on what was captured.
Cool. Thanks, Bizarre Bub. So far, so good, guys. So far, so good.
In this next video,
better.
A grandmother is celebrating her birthday while being surrounded by friends and family, all of whom are singing happy birthday to her.
Happy birthday to you.
She's loving it.
As the video plays out, it seems that this footage is nothing more than just a normal video of someone recording their grandma. Or at least, it seems like that. Because, as you continue to watch, something happens that makes this video the stuff of nightmares.
Yeah.
This is what was caught.
Nobody noticed. Nobody
As everyone noticed. Collectively sings, a shadow-like figure bolts behind the grandma. In a swift motion, the figure is gone.
That's the thing. If
it
nobody's
rushes
noticed,
over at full
I don't
speed,
know, man.
But not so fast that we
know.
Can't discern what this was. As viewers have noted, it kind of looks like a child, or a girl to be exact, who's running at an inhuman speed. Perhaps it was running so fast that no one had noticed it except the camera. Now this video becomes a whole lot creepier when reading the description it came with. As it states, the grandmother in this footage had a daughter who unfortunately passed away many years ago. When she was alive, she would often run around the house while playing with her older sibling.
Of course.
It's for this
course.
Reason that she believes that this was her spirit.
Yeah, no,
but as
yeah,
always,
I see that. I
you
see
be
that.
The judge on what was captured. Was a ghost caught on camera? Or had something else been caught?
I think that's always an iffy territory, isn't it? Like, I personally am a skeptic. I love the idea of the paranormal. I think there are things that are unexplainable. I totally get that. But I personally haven't had a horrific, crazy paranormal experience myself, you know? So that's why I like to say I'm a skeptic. But I'm all for it. I'm all for understanding these kind of things. But at the same time, like I said, it's even though there are things that line up really well for the story, which is interesting, it's the fact that it's conveniently exactly what you'd be able to sell that story as it was might have been the child running around, you know, from the past. But also, nobody else saw it, you know, and that's a big one for me. That's always a one where I'm like, okay, well, you know, I mean, yeah, things are fakeable. I'm not saying it is fake, but you know, it just makes it a little less believable if absolutely nobody else has seen it. But that's just me. That's just my take. Anyway, sorry, let me see what you guys are talking about. We're having a nice time, chat. We're having a nice time, aren't we? It's gotten better since we left Meat Canyon, I'll say that. Gmod was known for being a good game, and now it's known as Skibbity. It's a shame, isn't it? I really liked Gmod. But I liked Half-Life, you know. Grew up with that. That was like my youth. Let's see. Thankful your parents trust you with a phone at 10. Saw the Skibbity gods. Jesus. Wait, there are gods? I think it's like toilet gods or something. You know, I don't want to understand it. I'm just not going to. It was dead silent when it happened. I was talking about showing the, what was it, the 50-year-old Skibbity toilet? Just weird. Sorry, Bub is a guy I used to watch. Sir Spooks, Nuke's Top 5, and Bizarre are best spook. Oh, okay. I personally do like Nuke's Top 5. I've been subbed to him for quite a while, and I do quite enjoy his stuff. Grandmother is secretly dead, but mom and uncle won't accept it. Ah! I see what you did there. That's funny. That's real funny, McFace. That's real funny. On the ponytails, figure zoom pastor, blah, 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 blah. You tried to violate Graham. Arlo, I don't know where you came from, but you can stay. That's funny. That's horrible, but it's funny. If it happens to me, I'll believe it. Exactly. Exactly. That's how I approach the paranormal. If I have an experience, then I might fully believe it. But even so, I feel like little experiences wouldn't quite cut it. I'd need to have a proper like scare me experience. It's like I really don't know what happened there. I don't know how to explain it, and really spooked me kind of thing. McFace Gaming's house is haunted. Oh, okay, well, good luck with that. There's a remake version with the same name. I heard it too. It was based on the original. Oh, interesting. I was watching a Weird Birds video for the third time. Heard a loud bang on the roof, but no one else heard it in my house. Well, did it really happen then, McFace? Did it really happen? I mean, it did, because you heard it, but nobody else did. Strange. Closing your eyes in dark rooms while imagining the most heinous stuff ever. Yeah, Banana Man, are you all right? You all right there, buddy? You all right? That's probably not the best thing to do. Hey. Jaya Kapoor Films did make horror short films. Oh, okay. Jaya Kapoor Film, that sounds cool. Here's what we're going to do. I need another beer. So give me 2 seconds. I'll let you guys keep talking, and then we'll carry on with the video. It did mute me. Hang on. Sorry. It's because I got different settings. Hang on. You definitely said a fan on full breast. Just saying, even I saw that. It's okay. We all make typos. Don't worry about it. Oh. Okay. It autos to your most not said. Oh, to your most said things. You're calling them out there. That's funny. All right. Let's watch some more. Thought there was no audio for a minute there.
It's late at night when a man gets something on camera that leaves him extremely unsettled. The man recording this is known as Drosa, and on this night, he was looking after his little niece and nephew. He was taking care of them all by himself when his niece began to point at something in the dark. Drosa, their uncle, didn't think much of it until he noticed that she wouldn't stop pointing at the spot. Nothing appeared to be there, so Drosa wasn't sure as to what she was seeing, but as she kept on pointing, he began to think that maybe something is actually there. Feeling immensely unnerved, he records this video.
You could say neighbor and nope.
Then his door is just wide open over here.
Not the one.
Or just, I don't know. She's like looking over there like there's someone over there. She's freaking me out. Look, she's pointing. See? There's someone over there. I'm freaking out.
Can you show us where
she's... Who are you pointing at? Who is he? How can we keep pointing? Where's he at? Is he over there? Who is he? I'm not really sure who it is, but... Yeah, she's like pointing upwards. They must be tall or something.
No, she's adorable.
Look, she's pointing again, look.
His niece would not stop pointing at this spot for some reason. Even creepier is that she points towards the ceiling, suggesting that whatever is there is most likely tall. But as if things couldn't get any more creepy, Droza records this.
Yeah, she said something though. Like, it's crazy because, like, I don't know, I'm just babysitting my niece and nephew. My nephew's right here. Then it's her, and then she keeps pointing at something.
Excuse you? Oh. What's that? Battery?
You gotta get out of here, man. You gotta leave, man. Honestly.
Is that a battery?
You're not welcomed here. Leave. Whoever you are, leave. You're scaring my niece. Look, she keeps pointing at you. Get the f*** out of here, man.
It's crazy. She's just pointing. Just she's not screaming or anything. Tense, she's just pointing.
This happens. An object unexpectedly falls towards Droza and his niece. It's almost as though something had thrown it. Caught off guard, Droza is left speechless, but only to a certain point, because later he vents his frustration with whatever it was that was messing with him and his niece.
You gotta get out of here, man. You gotta leave, man.
He then stops recording and decides to ignore it. Despite everything, he still, to this day, has no idea as to what his niece was seeing at this hallway.
Well, wait till she's a little older. Bring her back, see if she does it again, and maybe she can talk to you a little bit. Just saying.
At approximately 3 p.m., a mother grabs her phone to record something highly unusual that just happened. This odd occurrence had taken place around the back entrance of the house. She films this video, hoping that it happens again, but only this time on camera. The only other time she's recorded this door was when one of her dogs had cracked the glass on the window pane. Although initially extremely upset, she now looks back at this memory with great nostalgia, as recently her dog was put to sleep.
Aww.
But fast forward to this exact day, and she's once again recording this door, when suddenly this happens.
Even when it's open, it's
like, does she have like a new glass pane? And it like gets hit or
something?
Can you move? She's taking a video. Can you see it?
It's coming back.
It's like a shadow. Yeah, do you see that? It looks like a dog's shadow. Oh.
Oh, it's got Derek.
Can you
move? Oh. Oh, that's cute though. Is he wagging his tail? Look at the back there. Just a little back right. It looks like he may be wearing. Oh. Oh, that's sad.
Me?
No, you're not. Wait, it's here.
Now it's disappearing. He's going to play with the dogs. And then it's going to come back.
That's so sweet, man. You know what? That's a sweet ghost. He's going to go play with the dog and then he's going to come back. So we're going to see him appear again. That's so interesting. That is so interesting. Oh, yeah, I think a little bit. Wow.
No, because when I'm looking at it, I can see a face a little bit.
Looking closely, a distinct outline can be made out. What looks to be the silhouette of a dog can be seen on the glass. It appears out of nowhere and stays in place as though waiting to be let inside.
Agreed, guys.
But it's only there momentarily before seemingly fading away. The family no doubt believes that this was the spirit of their belated dog who was sadly put down.
I can see that.
Although deeply saddened, they're happy to know that their presence is still here.
Yo.
Ghost or not, this footage reassures them that even if they had no choice but to put them down, their beloved pet will always be there, no matter what.
That's so nice. I wasn't expecting to have some feelings tonight, guys. Jesus. That was so. You know what? I want to be haunted by pets now. That's just awesome. Oh, except for the ones that kind of make a lot of noise. That would be annoying as shit. I would not enjoy that. Because you'd imagine like 3 o'clock in the morning, you know, you're getting phantom noises throughout your house. And you're like, shut the fuck up. I just want to go to sleep. But you can't find them because they're ghosts. That'd be annoying. That's sweet, man. That's real sweet. It's just a skinwalker trying to blend in. No, you cannot say the bad N-word, Arlo, because not only will you get banned, but then I will have to talk to YouTube and have some problems. So no. We're all a very inclusive place here. We're all here to have a good little time with each other, but we gotta follow the rules, you know. There's certain things you can't say, and that's definitely one of them. But that's okay. That's okay. It's just because you don't want to get banned, and then we don't want to maybe get me banned, you know, because that just doesn't work. It's okay. Don't worry. From what you can describe from them is that the Rokus are an ancient species. What on earth are you talking about, Haha? What have I missed? What the hell are you talking about? What? Oh, you're making a new story based on the origin of Dylan Lycan and Flashheart Lupin's friendship. Okay. So you are having a slightly different conversation going. That's okay. I just didn't understand the context. That's okay. Nobody, yeah, exactly. Nobody said you're a bad person, Arlo. Nobody said that. Don't misconstrue. You are welcome here. You're allowed to have a good time with all of us. We're just trying to keep you out of trouble as well as ourselves. Let's watch Simon.
In the following video, a group of friends are playing with a toy known as Simon, when out of nowhere, things take a very creepy turn. Now, it's worth noting this toy only has one function, which is to generate a pattern of lights and sounds for the player to memorize and win the game.
Simon Says, yeah.
Okay, so...
It's a simple game of short-term memory skill. However, in this video, it appears that the toy was acting beyond its intended purpose. Rather than generating patterns, it was answering questions.
Okay, I'll go. Okay, is my shirt black?
Ow.
Dude! Oh, dude! This thing is possessed, man. This thing is possessed.
That's good, no.
Am I a girl?
So now it should be red.
Oh! Dude,
Now, the video was taken at a house party where a group of friends gathered in the hostess' little sister's bedroom. The young sister was away from home. They had grown bored of the party downstairs, so they hung out here with all the toys and games. But little did they know that staying up here was a big mistake. This is their video.
What's going on?
Dude, he was acting up earlier.
Yeah, that's crazy.
You guys keep being here.
Alan said it was all good.
Really?
You're getting told off because you're hanging out in the little girl's room.
This thing is possessed, man. This thing is possessed. All right, okay. Ask a question.
What color is the sky? Wait. I guess I need to ask yes or no. Is the sky blue?
No! Dude, come ask it a question.
It's probably just like broken.
Dude, get over here. Ask it a question, dude.
First of all, it's not even yours.
It's kind of exhilarating.
Dude. Yeah.
Am I black?
Oh my god.
Oh! Oh! It knows, dude.
Throw that out.
It knows.
Like, tap on the green button or something.
Ask a no.
Am I a girl?
Oh!
Okay, so it knows. Dude, it knows, dude. So this thing's like one of those Ouija boards, dude.
Yeah,
like, it knows. Oh.
My mom played with one.
Come on, guys. Have you guys not seen horrible?
Nobody cares if your mom played with one.
The picture, dude. The picture.
The picture?
She drew that.
Yeah,
okay, come on. I mean, now it's becoming too much, right?
Dude, this will actually, like, tell.
Okay. Are you with us in this room?
Well, obviously they're going to say yes, because they're answering the questions in the room.
Like two fingers on
her
or something.
Oh, dude! Oh my gosh, that's so creepy. That is so creepy,
is that
dude.
Thing? Okay, is this
find that thing?
Dude, it's just on the floor, man.
Yo, are we actually haunted right now?
Dude, I'm like actually kind of scared, dude.
Yeah.
Like, what even is that?
Like that.
It's just weird that they conveniently have something like that.
Let's get real crazy.
Did you guys hear that there?
What?
Window? Okay,
it came from right here, yeah?
There. You guys hear that? We're on the second floor.
Oh! Okay, oh, alright.
Okay.
Alright, fine. That's enough.
Feeling totally creeped out, the group hurries out of the room, leaving everything behind. The tap on the window convinced them that something strange was indeed happening. According to them, it didn't make sense that someone was outside tapping on the window, considering that they were on the second floor. There was also no balcony. If no one...
Well, yeah, but... I mean, that doesn't mean somebody can't tap on it. Like, if people... I mean, if you've been in that room for clearly over 10 minutes, people want to mess with you and you're at a house party, I'm just saying,
had
they,
been outside,
they will mess
then
with
who,
you.
Then who, or even what, was at the window? While the group has yet to come up with an answer, they can't help but think that the figure in the picture had something to do with this. Viewers believe the toy was being used as a conduit for communicating with the group, and that the drawing, which may be the child's so-called imaginary friend, was responding to them through this toy. Although it's not certain if that's the case, the friends fully believe that it was.
What color is the sky?
I mean, look, I'm not saying that they faked it. I'm not trying to say that. I'm just saying that one feels a little too good to be true. You know, like everything conveniently scary worked out in this one situation. It's just a little fishy, in my opinion. Hello, my people. Serious Summer, welcome to the chat. What are you saying? Like that one Paranormal Activity film, The Marked Ones. I don't think I've seen that one. Paranormal Activity, I've only seen, I think, the first two or three, and then, I mean, they apparently just kept making more of them, and I didn't end up watching anymore because, you know, I had better stuff to do in life, as people do. My Howler, he is carrying on with his cool story. Mikos, the Matt Rose of the Disturbing Meta Congratulate. Thank you, Mikos. Thank you very much, my dude. Appreciate that. Rootkit, welcome back, my dude. Good to see you. Good to see you putting out more stuff, by the way. Very good. Very good. Let's see. Face Gaming, a small rock can do the same thing. Yep, I would agree. Pineapple, hey, welcome to the chat, my dude. You people probably share the same outlook on this wide genre as I do. Yeah, I like to think that we're all here for a good time. We're all here for a good time, you know? You do have a lot of new uploads on Rootkit, I know. I'm still subscribed to you. I'm not gonna ever change that. I can see. It's always good, man. It's always very good. Like I said, we're probably going to have to do another proper watch party of some more of your stuff. It's going to be exciting. Arlo is having a little too much fun. Just constantly laughing. Which is being considered spam in the chat. So just be wary, buddy. Just be wary. It does consider what you do in spam. Yeah. And it's causing me to have to review all of them. So. One is fine. Serious Summer, hello. Miko's going to change his username to Miko Blixel. That's what you feel like doing right now. Fair enough, buddy. No worries. Pineapple, I work too. That's okay, man. That's okay. Life is what it is. We all have to do work, you know. Nothing wrong with that. Life goes on, but hey, we're always here for you. Don't worry. Mace Face Gaming. My dad made me watch Paranormal Activity when you were little. Yeah, it's scary. There's no doubt it's scary. Probably why I had the worst insomnia. Yeah, I see that. I totally see that. Banana Man's gonna go play some nostalgic games. Fair. Totally fair. Harlow's starting his villain arc right now. He kind of is, isn't he? I miss you too, Pineapple. Ah, you're Algis. Good, my dude. Good. Good to see you. I just didn't recognize your face, that's all. Ugh. Okie dokie. Let's watch a bit more of this show. We're going to skip past that. It's a baby monitor. Ooh, those are always fun. Those always pick up creepy things.
This next video was recorded by a father who swears that something unexplainable was captured on his baby monitor. It was on December 20th of 2023 when this incident took place. Around 9 p.m, he and his wife were having playtime with their two kids before going to bed. They usually play games such as tag or hide and seek. But unlike other times, something happens that to this day the father can't explain. He records the footage of this incident on his phone. Take a look.
It's good. You can have a bit of fun. That's always important to do. You gotta have a bit of fun. Sounded like somebody did a high. Oh, but is somebody not in there? Now that's interesting. Because, yeah, it even sounded like somebody said hi. Okay. I'm curious.
But we're downstairs.
I too would be confused.
Heart attack here.
Oh, this is stressing me out.
You're stressed out.
What?
You might even change my diaper.
Thinking that his wife or kid was hiding in the closet, he waits for them to come out. But unbeknownst to him, no one was inside. Understandably, the father was totally freaked out. He swears that right before the door opened, he heard a voice.
I thought I did too. See? Sounded like hi.
Looking back at this clip, he can finally rest assured that he wasn't just hearing things, but rather having actually heard something. Despite having no explanation for this odd occurrence, the family has been getting comments from those who believe that something supernatural had occurred. But regardless of what this could have been, the family is adamant on keeping the closet locked. As they state, they'd rather forget about this whole incident and hope that it doesn't happen again.
Yeah, that's fair. That's fair. That's a fair reaction. I think I would do the same.
If you caught something creepy on camera, or if there's any ghost videos you'd like me to check out and include in the next compilation, you can send them over to scaryvideos444@gmail.com.
Sorry, chat. I'm with you. Don't worry. I'm with you. It's hard to juggle. That's all. Let's see. Banana Man, never in his entire life will buy a baby monitor. Well, never say never. You never know. Especially if it catches creepy shit like that. You never know. Among that, Zero Blackfire was the first high horn to ever walk among a planet. Okay, High Howler is still giving us some interesting lessons. Arlo is still here, having a good little laugh. That's cool. Mace Face Gaming, I would have wet myself. Yeah, I would have too, but like the dad said, you know, he needs his diaper changing too. And I'm like, you know what? Yeah, I probably would have said the same. Oh, you gotta go, Al Jazz Pineapple. No worries, my dude. You take care, my pal. Serious Summer's having a good time with us. That's good. Yes, excuse me. I'm so sorry. So sorry. Why do we forget to become a caveman when we get scared? What? Why don't they just put the baby's crib in their room? Yeah. Well, you see, now I've never had children, but I do understand the notion of having a baby crib not in your room, because then you don't have the immediately loud shrieking of the baby crying next to you. At least if they do start crying, they're in a different room. It's a little more muffled. I mean, I'm not saying you're not going to hear it, but you know, it doesn't immediately pierce your ears. That would be my guess. Plus, you know, inevitably you have to have the kids get used to sleeping in a different area anyway, so they can be more independent from you. That's just my thoughts on the matter. We're having a good time. We're having a good time. Whenever you get scared in roller coasters and that kind of stuff, you don't scream. You just go dead silent, and everyone has to ask me if I just passed out. That is pretty creepy. That is, I mean, you know what? I'm glad that you know what works for you and your things. That's good. I know I would have a little reaction. I definitely do have reactions to stuff, you know. But going dead silent, that's something. That's pretty something. You'd rather hear your baby crying than the chance to not hear them crying. I get you. That's fair, Banana Man. To each their own. But I guess that's also another reason why people get baby monitors. So that way, in case you can't hear them normally, you'd hear them through the monitor. Fair enough. Let's go on.
That being said, let's get back to the video.
I agree, Bizarre Bub. Thank you.
Now, this next video comes from a woman named Morgan Lambert, who, while being on a farm in the Appalachian Mountains, captures something pretty spooky on camera. Exact location of this farm is unknown, but Morgan mentions that the property is owned by her family, who've had more than a couple of paranormal experiences on this land. The video starts off with Morgan recording a silly moment with her husband, who came along with her to visit her family's farm. They're here to check the property, as recently, strong winds have struck the place. But as she vlogs, something happens that prompts her to stop recording. As Morgan claims, her own voice was heard coming from the distance, beckoning to her husband. Mind you, she was right next to him when this happened. Take a look.
But not in like an echo effect?
No, you got it. We're on an adventure. Check on the fence line to make sure no trees fell on it, because we had like 50 mile an hour winds. We're gonna check it instead of my dad. Oh god, I'm freezing.
It's cold, isn't it?
Pretty. Oh god.
What?
I'm a spell.
What did you say to that?
I said, oh god. Okay. Sure.
Okay. That's fair. Okay, so it can't be an echoing effect, because obviously it's not mimicking exactly what she's saying, just maybe a couple of seconds apart. Because I know in certain funny terrain areas that an echo effect can have like a delay of up to a few seconds. So I thought it was going to be something like that, but that is not the case. There, yeah, I think you guys are right. Skinwalker's going on.
I said, oh god, because I no, I really did. What are you talking about? What are you talking about?
We gotta go.
Hey, don't run. It's okay. We're good. I don't be here.
Go.
Okay. It's okay.
Are you messing with me right now?
Hey, I don't hear anything.
You don't hear.
It's hard to make out what's being said with all the wind in the background, but if you listen closely, the words baby and hey can be made out. But further adding to the weirdness of this incident is the fact that Morgan didn't hear anything. Based on the footage, her husband was the only one hearing the voice.
Thank you, Mar Martian.
I just said, oh god, because I not really good.
Upon hearing it, he was totally spooked. With no one else having been there, the question is begged. Just who, on this vast land in a secluded part of the Appalachians, was beckoning to the husband?
There was a lot of wind, but it was faint, but you could hear a voice, which sometimes did sound like her. I'll give it that. Can't hear anything over the wind. 100%. Yeah, imagine hearing your own voice. Yeah, I gotta admit, I would be pretty spooked about that out in public. But obviously, because I do a lot of like video editing and stuff, I do hear myself a lot. But I'm used to that. You know, you get used to it. Arlo's having a ooga booga moment. He's having good laughs. That's good. It's not the reaction normal human would have. Yeah, you're right, Banana Man. You totally right. Totally right. Be running, get the fuck out of there. 100%. Which is kind of what he was having. So, I respect that.
This last video comes from Edgar V, and in this footage, Edgar is recording a toy mirror that belongs to his daughter. She's been playing with this toy ever since Edgar's neighbor had given it to his family. They've had this toy for quite some time, but as of recent, they now think it's best to get rid of it. Edgar says that just a few nights ago, he was passing by his daughter's room when he heard her talking to the mirror. It sounded like she was having a full-blown conversation with someone else. Now, it should be noted that this mirror does actually talk. it would say pre-recorded things like, hello, or hi, I'm the magical mirror. But this time, it was saying things that didn't seem pre-recorded. From odd responses to creepy questions, the toy seemed almost alive. In this short clip, Edgar and his wife interact with the mirror.
Pre-recorded messages.
Nosotras seremos mejores amigas.
¿Tu personaje favorito?
Si papá pregunta, mi favorito es mi papi. Si mamá pregunta, yo responderé que la que más me gusta es mi mami.
Oh, unless it records her
pregunta,
as well. Uh-huh.
Te diré que el que más me gusta eres tú. Soy una niña muy inteligente.
Now viewers couldn't help but notice how quickly the toy responds. According to some, it seemed a little too fast for an average toy like itself. Some have even pointed out that it shouldn't be speaking, as they themselves have this exact toy, but theirs doesn't talk or say anything like Edgar's. It's for this reason that the family decided to store the toy inside their shed. Over time though, Edgar's children would come in and mess with the toy. From scrapping it to beating it up, a number has been done to this mirror. Because of this, Edgar had to replace some parts. But nevertheless, the toy still works. In this short clip, he shows the toy once again, as viewers want to see if it gives the same responses as last time.
That's juicy.
But as he
Let's
films,
go.
He gets this.
Let's go.
Hola. Gracias, amigo. Me da gusto.
Eres muy divertido. ¿Tienes una fiesta?
No, no tengo fiesta. ¿Tú tienes?
No sé. Cuando me levanté, te vi a ti.
¡Ay, vas y chingas a tu madre!
Just like before, the toy talks back at the right time, as though responding like a real person. The fact that it also says responses different from before has convinced the family that it's unlike any other toy. They think that it might be cursed or haunted. Whatever the case might be, they don't want to mess with it and think it's best if they keep it away from their home. To this day, the family has yet to know what exactly is going on with this toy. As always, let me know your thoughts on this one.
I would so love to interview that toy. I would so love that. Thank you for subscribing, Holly Morin. Thank you, very kind. It's so for me, my first thought is it's the new age Furby. 100%. Because Furby's gonna stay for the concert if it happens. Are you talking about the with the hearing your own voice? I get you. Just throw it out. Why keep it if it doesn't work? Because if it's potentially haunted, that's a bit more fun. I mean, to be fair, I understand that. Especially if you keep the haunting separate from your own house. That's fair. I remember back when I was doing the Badlands Boys Urban Exploration stuff, which is another channel I've got. Not that we don't really do that anymore because I don't live in that area, but one conversation we were having was about like if we would use a Ouija board, and we all kind of came to the consensus of like, well, I mean, we probably would give it a go, but we wouldn't do it where we live. We would do it somewhere else, so that if something did happen, it would be somewhere else, and we wouldn't bring it home. You know, that was our thought process on it. Does that mean that would work? I can't guarantee it. I mean, you don't know. Do spirits follow you home? I mean, I think they can. If they exist, I think they would be able to. Why not? Who says they can't? We don't know. But you know, that's my two cents on that. Something is not right with the toy mirror. Yeah, burn it. Yeah, it's good point. Strawberry Shortcake. Who now we know is named Morgan. You think I wouldn't pay attention? Not shitting myself scary. Yeah. Imagine it screams from pain. You just set it on fire and the dream castle's like, ah! I would hate that so much. Toys are creepy, but they don't creep you out enough. That's fair. I wouldn't say they're like super creepier toys, but it's just the notion. It's just the notion that this is something you can buy outright pretty much at any store. You know, I think that's the part for me. I'm like, it's accessible creeps, which is kind of silly. Looks like there's a face in the mirror. Oh, okay. I guess I could kind of see that. Toys Alive, sell it. Arlo is still in his Ooga Booga moments. That's good. They keep having to be reviewed because they think he's... YouTube robots think he's spamming. That's all. So I just have to approve the comments. I mean, if I feel like you are spamming, I might leave it. But, you know, otherwise, if I think you just have it a laugh, that's fine. Would be cool to have, though. Yeah, I mean, I think it would be cool to have in a secure container somewhere, you know, or maybe in a storage unit, because then at least the storage unit place is haunted and not my house. I think that's my two cents. Would you not want to talk to the dead? I mean, I would. I don't not want to talk to the dead. It was very kind, though. That's true. The toy was very kind, wasn't it? It was very kind toy. At least that's nice, right? It's not an evil spirit if there is one. There was no threat from it. True Isaac, welcome to the chat, my dude. Welcome, welcome. Hi. Karuk was a pup. Hi Howler is... He's still going, man. He's still going. Toys have no power over us. Just kick it or burn it. Foof. My God, he's always got the frozen spoiled pizzas. Honestly, you gotta do something about that freezer, my dude. Something ain't right about it. What's my opinion on orange juice? It's a fantastic thing. I tend to have orange juice multiple times a week. You know, it's usually one of the things to start my day. Other juices are available, but orange juice is just, it's one of the most readily available ones. And I try to get the not from concentrate ones because I think that's better for you ultimately. It's also not watered down. Costs a little bit more, but it's a price worth paying in my opinion. I love orange juice. It's awesome. I forgot I said me and the girl the same. It's okay, strawberry shortcake. It's okay. I do pay attention, though. Not always, but sometimes. Sometimes I'm on it. Sometimes I'm on it. Hi, Howler's watching Superman Returns, Mace Face. Are we sure these people aren't just playing Phasmophobia in real life? They could be. They absolutely could be. Or they've just conveniently got a toy that they were able to manipulate in such a way that they can make it look like it was haunted. I could totally believe that, too. Serious Summer. Imagine you sit down at this to communicate with ghosts. Yeah, I love that concept now. So imagine you're a ghost hunting channel or whatever, you know, like typical hardcore looking intros and stuff, and you're like, all right guys, we're gonna interact with a haunted object. Oh wow, amazing. And you pull up to the place and this is it. you got like some big tough looking dude who sits down on the little dinky pink stool and it's in the castle thing opens. I love it. That's so funny. Oh God. What's my opinion on orange juice after I brush my teeth? A terrible idea. Terrible idea. Also very damaging. So you know, you need to give your teeth usually about 30 minutes for it to really kind of take effect with toothpaste and mouthwash and stuff before you start doing things. Because otherwise it'll damage your enamel. And sugary things are the most damaging. But also flavor-wise, just awful. Wouldn't do it. You do have the same name, though. Well, that's good. That's good, strawberry shortcake. Do good ghosts exist? I would think so. I don't think all ghosts are bad. That would just be too silly, right? Now, you know what people don't talk about? Why aren't there any dinosaur ghosts? If there can be ghosts, why are there not even older ghosts? Dinosaurs, cavemen, what about like, you know, from World War One? I guess there might be a couple of those, you know, and then obviously you got, what about like Romans? I mean, Roman legionaries, you know, why not all these other kind of older spirits? Just my point. Oh, you like the Red Monkey video, True? Thank you. I thought it was quite enjoyable. It just sadly didn't end fantastically, but the end credits were clearly where all the money went, because that was really good. But the concept was fun. The concept was very fun. Have I seen Basswood County? Foof, good reminder. I have not seen Basswood County. That is such a good point. That's a very good point. Good. I'm so glad I'm so glad that we're all on the same point about why wouldn't there be older ghosts? Because it's true. I mean, think of all the other ghost hunting shows or YouTube things or whatever that you've seen. And they always tend to find ones that are a little more relevant to what they're doing, right? Which is fair enough. I'm not arguing that point. I mean, they're more recent ghosts, I suppose. That makes sense. But it's just weird that they also don't catch things that they wouldn't expect. You know what I mean? The fact that there aren't other things that they catch. I just always found that to be a little weird. In my opinion. Well, here's what I'm thinking, guys. I'm thinking we'll now watch a Nuke's Top 5, because I think there's a new one that I haven't seen. There is a new one I haven't seen. Awesome. So we're going to watch this, because I love me some Nuke's Top 5. I'm not subscribed on my Nate Dog. I'm subscribed on my Nate Narrates, because that was my typical channel. So don't get confused, but I will.
Urban
will
Explorers
read
from the YouTube channel Urbex Castronautica visit the historic La Plata Cemetery in Buenos Aires, Argentina. Ones. The cemetery was built in 1886 and is the final resting place of many notable figures. But while wandering through the huge cemetery's 12,000 tombs and vaults, the guys stumble upon a crypt that has been vandalized. Their camera captures something downright chilling.
Oh, that's proper vandalized. Dang. Just amazing. Amazing and horrifying. Yeah, why would you...
Did you see it?
No.
No?
No.
Well, neither did the guys who filmed it. You see, after posting this video to YouTube, their sharp-eyed viewers were freaked out when they noticed a creepy little pale hand pulling back into an open coffin.
Okay.
Now, it happened so quick that it's hard to see without brightening the footage and analyzing it frame by frame. But when the footage is converted to a negative image, the spooky little hand is a bit easier to see.
That's
now,
fair.
It's very unlikely that anyone could have crawled into that coffin to fake this. This crypt is very old and unstable, and it would be very dangerous for someone to just climb inside. So did this group of urban explorers accidentally capture proof of the paranormal? Well, as usual, you decide. You can watch this entire video over on the YouTube channel, Urbex Castronautica. Trapped. In this next video...
He always gets... Yeah, I love the fact... He always gets just things from all over the world. It's amazing. I love Nukes. I love Nukes. Sorry, what are we talking about? We're having some laughs again. Can we watch... Oh, hang on. Is that what orbs are? Ooh. That's an interesting thought, Sirius. That's an interesting thought. Can we watch Woodland National Park after? Woodland National Park. That sounds familiar. Let me see. I don't think I made a note about it, but I can. I sure can. Oof. Done those. So there's Basswood County and Woodland National Park. Of course I misspell it because I am a silly person. I can't guarantee we'll watch those things today, but the fact is they are on the list, which means that before a Saturday we will absolutely. But it depends. It depends on how long we decide to do all this for, et cetera, you know? In which case, I feel like we can definitely move on to an analog horror. Very possible. Very possible. POV, you're a ghost. A Colombian ghost hunter kicks down the door and proceeds to chase after you. That's true. We never think about it from the ghost perspective, do we? We never do. You got to think, ghosts have got to have seen so many ghost hunters, they have to have been asked so many questions, they probably hate it at this point. That's a good point, Foof. Strawberry Shortcake says, maybe they're a dinosaur ghost, but we can't talk to them because they can't talk. Yeah, you still think you would catch something of them, right? I mean, they must be making noises, they must be doing certain things, I don't know. It's just food for thought, isn't it? It's food for thought. But you're right, we wouldn't really be able to properly communicate with them. You're right. How do people notice this? I don't know. How do people... Yeah, no, is that like that little thing? Exactly. People have no life, do they? Oh, they're all having all of some laughs. Dat by boy, welcome to the chat, my dude. I haven't seen no through road. See no through road, four parts. Hang on, I'll pop it on. I'll pop it on here. No. Through. See, I'm always happy for good suggestions. You know, and Meat Canyon was just sadly not one of them. Nothing, I mean, it's I can't really say much great about it. But no, that's good. I'm happy to check out some stuff, absolutely. The National Park has, like, lots of stuff that they post in one app and not on other ones. Oh, right, okay, okay. No Through Road is so great. It's one of those that creep me out. Okay. Well, even Banana Man. Okay. The more people that can rate something, I think that really helps too. Okay. Cool. Well, that's on the list. No worries. Kwong192, hello. Welcome, my dude. Thank you, Dat Bye Boy. I appreciate you at least liking the stream. It's okay if you can't make it, man. You know, I mean, we all live in different time zones. Things are tricky, but you'll always be able to see them on demand. No worries about that. And watch this road stream. Oh, you mean No Through Road. Okay, okay. Arla Bloomberg, you watch my vids while playing Minecraft. That's good, man. That's good. I'm glad they helped make your day. Ah, Kwong is back. Good to have you back, Kwong. Good to have you back. The dog analog I heard about and just... Dog... Oh, are you talking about the... what is it? Dog Nightmares, I think? That one's quite strange. That one is quite strange. I do like it, though. I do like it. This is like just in my peripheral vision and it just... It, blurs me out sometimes. Have you heard Sleep Well by CG5? Sleep Well? No. No, I have not, so that's yet another one I have to look at. Sleep Well by CG5. This is good. More good recommendations is good, because I can at least check them out. Maybe I need to start vetting things before I fully commit to them as a stream. Just so we don't have another Meat Canyon, because that was just a bit too fucking... It was like a little more Cronenberg than I was ready for. Sinkhole is also a good one. But if you want, you can watch it. It's pretty middle of the road in terms of analog horror. Okay, okay. Sinkhole. Well, you know, I mean, the more things I can at least check out and potentially have us watch for a stream is cool. It's cool. They could just talk in dinosaur noises, but we can't hear them because maybe the thing that ghost hunters use to talk to ghosts doesn't pick it up. You know what? That's also a good point. That is also a really good point. Are we able to pick up every kind of noise frequencies possible? No, we're not. We absolutely cannot. Or else, obviously, we could debunk an awful lot more things. You were totally right. That is a fantastic point. Strawberry Shortcake, fantastic point. It's okay, guys. Don't worry. Don't worry about running out of ideas. We're all good. Heard about it near a neighborhood. Watch Local 58. We've seen Local 58. That one's awesome. I love Local 58. Local 58 and Gemini are both just some of the top notch. Some of the top notch. 100%. But thank you, Elijah. Always a good recommendation. 100% agree with you.
A man is taking a short video of a car that he's planning to sell. The vehicle belonged to his sister, who tragically passed away right inside the car over a year and a half ago. After sending the footage to a potential buyer, he gets an alarming message saying he should really check the video closer.
Hey man, here's my sister's car. Just wanted to make this video so you could have a look at it. She still runs good. She's a little dirty. She has a lot of miles on her, but it can clean up nice. Here's the front.
It's like she's crying.
A little back. Here's some in the back. But I don't know. If you're interested, just let me know what you think.
Throughout the footage, the faint sound of a woman crying can be heard. The video was shared online by These Dark Adventures and quickly gained nearly 500,000 views. In the video comments, many concerned viewers believe that the voice belongs to the spirit of the man's sister who passed away inside the car, and that her soul is still trapped, unable to move on. Motorcycle Mystery. In the city of Cagayan de Oro in the Philippines, a motorcycle rider is driving down a busy road that is notorious for being the site of many fatal accidents. He is about to experience something that is truly bizarre.
Oh, God. Where did they go? That's always creepy.
Someone appears to jump right into the motorcycle's path, but when the rider looks back, there's no one there.
They just disappear.
And it gets even weirder, because the motorcycle rider claims that whoever this was, they didn't appear to have a face, only a strange dark blur. Now, many locals believe that the rider saw the ghost of someone who passed away on the dangerous road. But if this wasn't anything supernatural, then just what happened here? Let me know what you think. Open house.
Those kind of videos always intrigue me so much. But when it's like somebody that you see and then like instantly gone, it tends to happen a lot with vehicle movement videos, like people driving on a highway or a road or whatever, or in that case, you know, a motorcycle. It's always so fascinating. Always so fascinating. But I'm always intrigued. Because it's like, how could you explain that? Especially when you can see quite a fair bit of detail in their stature. I think it's just incredible. Absolutely incredible. Wygo done that. Well, yeah. Watch Sleep Well. It's a Poppy Playtime song. Oh, yeah. Yes, it is a Poppy Playtime song. I didn't even think about that. It's a good point, Kwong. It's a good point. To Poppy Playtime. I still haven't played the first two. Guess I'll have to do that at one point on Nate Dogg. But that's fine. I can always do that as just like a video on demand kind of thing. Do that. Okay, so I am thirsty. So give me 2 secs. I'm gonna go get another beer and we'll crack on. Good plan. Boo, 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 boo. I'm back. Hey, just insane people. You just got the news that your school closed for one day. Got to sleep well. Fair. It's always important. Educating yourself is important. It's always good. Always smart. Or just insane people. I was talking about the crazy disappearing motorcycle stuff. I'm with you. School sucked for you, in your opinion. I'm sorry to hear that, Xversity. Sorry to hear that. I mean, school is not always the most fun, you know. But believe me when I say having an education, it does help. It does help a lot. It allows you, it does open a fair amount of doors. But then after that, it's mostly the skills that you can bring to the table. The things that you are capable of yourself as well. So it's a mix of stuff. But I do find education helps. But it depends on the people around as well. God, this is such a freaking mess. Eh. Dang it, I wasn't on ready for a messy one. School can be good and bad. Sometimes you have the best time in school, and sometimes the others just make it worse. Ah. But Animan's totally with me then. Horror Shorts Party and Terrence Nicholson. He's your favorite voice actor. Horror Shorts Party. Terrence Nicholson. I'll write it down. Don't recognize that. Don't recognize it. Horror Shorts Party. Terrence Nicholson. Kwong, we're not gonna listen to Sleepwell right now. We're still watching this, but it's on the list. We can listen to some songs if you want as well. We can do that. Xversity got stabbed in the neck. Jesus. Okay, yeah, that's shitty. That's totally shitty. I'm with you. That's bad, man. I'm really sorry to hear that. That's crap. I do not know how to pronounce your name, my friend. I'm so sorry. Messi. Cernikowski? Message? Cernikowski? I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm so sorry. How's the stream only got 11 viewers? It happens. It's not a big deal. I'm here to hang out. That's all I care about. Just having a laugh. You know. Don't have to be the biggest. Don't have to be the most popular. Doesn't really bother me. It's a good question, man. How is Xversity alive? I feel like we need an interview with this now, right? Hi Howler is still telling us more about the Rokus. Awesome. Not to be confused with the popular digital Roku entertainment system. Xversity says it wasn't that bad. Just the edge of a necklace. Well, okay. Still hurts. Give Hi Howler some credit. He said it first. Of course he gets the credit. Oh, it's a Polish name. Huh? Can you teach me how to pronounce it? Just so I at least have an idea. Arlo is still standing. I'm proud of you. Well done. Right. Let's watch a little more, shall we?
Reddit user / realtor Sandra is recording a tour of a 1960s bungalow-style home to show prospective buyers. Sandra's filming at night in order to showcase the house's interior lighting. But it's starting to get a bit late at the creepy little cottage, and things are about to get weird.
Hi.
Wow, it's 10 p.m. and my day was fully booked with showings of this beautiful vintage 1962.
I get it. I do it too.
Wow, it's 10 p.m. and my day was fully booked with showings of this vintage 1963 bungalow.
Excuse you? Doesn't even have a lock on it, man. Look at that, just the doorknob. Well, should put a lock on it. A lot. It doesn't look like it would be very secure, if I'm honest with you. I mean, it's still creepy, but just saying. Is it one of those like little button roundy ones? They've opened it.
Camera.
What are they? What are you? They probably just can open it. If you close it and ask, then they might do it. I mean, it's still spooky, don't get me wrong. I just...
Open this door.
A door that doesn't have, like, a lock on it and stuff. I mean, it's... Some doors can be fiddly if you don't properly close it. Just saying that some of it can be explained.
Go ahead, open this door.
They're open? What are you talking about? They're open.
Open this door like you do the other one.
Oh, you mean like further. Oh, right. Why don't you close a door and then ask it to open it? It's a pretty spacious bungalow, though.
Come on, just move a glass or something.
You're just asking too much now. Can't do like an impromptu ghost hunt out of the blue, man. That door.
Go ahead, do it again.
Paint damage.
Not scared.
You sure? Is anything else gonna happen? The archways kind of weird me out a bit. Because they're not like... Okay.
A door suddenly swings open on its own and Sandra is spooked. But she gathers her courage and rushes out to see what's going on. A glass of water sitting on top of the fireplace shifts and slowly moves as if it's being pushed by some invisible force.
Very
slightly. But things get even crazier as a smoke detector suddenly starts to beep before crashing violently to the floor. With that, Sandra has had enough and just gets out of there. But there's also something else that is very creepy in this video.
Oh, yeah.
Something that only a few viewers even notice. So again, I ask, did you see it?
No.
Right before the door moves, a face in the picture right beside Sandra seems to slowly darken. And then the creepy little shadow fades away just as the door swings open. Sandra says that she's experienced several unexplained paranormal events in this home, but this was the first time that she finally captured it on camera. We need scary videos.
That's a new one. Darkening a little like picture thing. That's new. That's new. Pretty strange. High Howler has the determination you could never have. He's very determined. You do have to give High Howler that. He's definitely coming up with, definitely always got some very interesting stories. I just wish that High Howler would put some of these stories maybe in the Discord so that we could maybe properly read them. Because it is hard to read them all in a live stream format, I'm afraid. But I do admire the creativity. I do admire that. Please close the door, Ghosty. Yeah, at least close the door if you're going to open it, right? Like, just if you're going to open it, just close it. One door opens, another door closes, right? Or no, it's the other way around. Shit. High Howler says, I'm starting to think the place she lives in is haunted. Yep. 100%. 100%. Looks like one of those doors that pops open if it isn't closed properly. That's what I'm thinking. Because, I mean, there are just some funny doors, and it definitely didn't look like it was a very secure door. Also, it even had the hole for where a lock could go, which really kind of emphasized the fact that it's not a very secure door. I mean, not to say it wasn't a paranormal thing. I'm just trying to look at it from something else. Now, the smoke alarm, that was pretty weird. I'll give it that. Totally give it that. Ghosts don't be doing requests. Yeah, they tend to not, right? But anyway, man, I would actually love to experience paranormal activities. I would actually just record no edits. Exactly, right? That's how I feel like. I would love to just go on an experience and just see what happens. And then I would also love the fact that I wouldn't really have to edit anything. You know, I could just cut out some stuff. That's it. That's so much easier to deal with than doing any other kind of fucking editing. That's crazy. Ghost gets a little angry. Something knocked the alarm off. What if the ghost doesn't speak English? That's a good point. That's a good question. I guess you could always Google Translate. But you'd have to hope you could figure out what language. Also another question. Anybody explored abandoned places before? Of course, Banana Man. I have explored a few. I just haven't done that in quite some time. But it's always exciting. One of the ones we went to, it's got like an abandoned skate park, an abandoned like, it's not really a silo, but it's an old like munitions factory, which was quite interesting. And some people were using one part of it for satanic rituals. So we did catch a little area of where they were using that for. So that was interesting. That was quite strange. Very weird. There's certainly a lot of weird things out there. We were hoping to also go to Aleister Crowley's house, but somebody ended up buying it, which meant that people could no longer go to it, which sucked, because that was on our list. The painting was somehow darkening. Yeah, it's quite weird. You have Wattpad? You have Wattpad? What is that, like a notepad application, maybe? The scariest part is the invisible strings. You funny, man. I love it. Exactly. Some things can just easily be faked, sadly. It is true. It is true. Should you make a video horror story? Oh, Xversity. If you have one in mind, my friend, if it is something you would like to do, I'm absolutely in support of you doing that. I think that would be a great idea. You just need to let us know that you're doing it so that maybe we can cover it sometime. What language would I like to learn? So I know a little bit of Spanish. I know maybe two words in French. And I know like a couple of words in a few languages, but nothing crazy properly fluent. I'd say English is obviously my first one. Spanish would be kind of a second. It's not really, I'm not heavily fluent in it, but if I were to listen to people speaking Spanish, I can kind of comprehend what's going on because I took it for a few years. But I feel like I would like to be more fluent in it just because I feel like it's still a fairly common language, you know? But then again, at the same time, probably Chinese, like Mandarin Chinese, I think would be quite useful as well. But that's a hard one to learn. What if you record yourself exploring abandoned places? Banana Man's a member for a whole month. Just sponsored. What does that mean? I don't know what that means. There's still so many things about this current journey I'm on that I don't understand. I don't know what that means. Oh, I guess it's like renewed your membership, maybe? Thank you, Banana Man. Thank you. As always, one of my best. I don't know what you did either, but I'm going to thank you anyway. It showed up as an alert, so I'm taking it, you know, and you're taking the credit. Don't worry about what it was. We're not going to worry about it until, you know, I don't think it's a problem. It's fine. But if you're saying record myself exploring abandoned places, I'd love to be able to do more of that again. I just haven't really been able to get around to it because it's just another one of those things that requires time, money, and a level of investigation, which, I mean, I've got a GoPro and things like that. You know, it'd be fun to do again. And it's definitely still been on my mind. I just haven't quite figured out the semantics behind it yet. But I'm thinking about it. I'm thinking about it. It is what it is. It would be like the Lurchers. Wattpad is an app where you can write stories and publish them. Oh. Oh, okay. Oh, excuse me. God, I'm so rude to them. So sorry, guys. You can also read people's stories. Okay. I will investigate Wattpad then. It's good to know. Very interesting. Good to know. Try learning Polish. Is it a hard language? I have no idea. Wattpad even have a YouTube channel? Okay, I'll check them out. I'll definitely check them out. Because if there's cool stories, I mean, that's definitely worth checking out.
So if you see a scary video that you think would be great on the top 5, email us at nukestop5@gmail.com. Flickr. Reddit user Sybseb says that his mother is taking care of a young foster child at her home in England. One night, a TV is playing a cartoon in the child's bedroom, but the flickering light from the screen reveals something that the Reddit user and his mom simply can't explain. Something that is downright creepy.
Thank you for subscribing to powerful music. Has he disappeared? What the fuck? What? What?
Someone seems to be seated in the chair. A small pale face illuminates in the flashing light from the TV screen.
Oh my god, it's Dear David.
Then the face just disappears.
David got tired.
Reddit user Sybseb wonders if his mother's security camera accidentally captured a paranormal presence. But what do you think this is? The Fond du Lac UFO. Around 2 a.m., Florissa Bonnelly and her family friends are driving home to Fond du Lac, Saskatchewan, Canada. Suddenly, Florissa spots something very odd in the night sky.
It looks like a UFO, right? That's a UFO!
I'm just,
Can you angle your camera a little better?
Look, it's just above there.
Are you recording it?
Yeah! That's a UFO!
Or a drone.
You can just see it!
Well, hide, you know.
Bro, you can just see it's like the round.
Just keep movie. Recording it.
It's a little YouTube. It won't expire.
Everyone is shocked as they witness a strange circular object with flashing lights soaring through the sky. Florissa's mother posted the video to Facebook, and friends and local residents immediately began to respond that they too have seen the strange UFO. Eyewitness reports in the thread go all the way back to January 1990. So just what could this mysterious flying object be? Let me know what you think down in the comments.
Well, I mean, my first thought was the fact that it could have just been a drone. Drones are quite impressive these days, you know, absolutely. And some of them could be quite big and stuff, but... And the fact that, you know, they were driving, I wouldn't say incredibly fast, and the fact you could kind of see it moving, but it didn't look like the UFO was moving. It was more like the car was moving, which changed the perspective, which made it feel like it wasn't actually very far away, which yet again made me think it was a drone. But if there were sightings of I mean, there's no guarantee what they saw back in 1990 was this. I don't know. That's tricky. That's kind of tricky. I'm still thinking it's a drone, personally. It's not the most convincing UFO video. You know. It's cute fun, though. It's always cute fun. It's always fun to believe. I mean, I think there could be life out there, 100%. I mean, you know, there's bacteria and stuff, but I think there's intelligent life out there. I think that's a possibility. We just haven't met them yet.
Follower. Nick Perry says that late one night he was driving down the allegedly haunted Dyers Lane Road in Roseville, California. He says that he saw an ominous dark shadow figure appear in the middle of the road. Nick believes that this dark entity followed him home and says that he now experiences terrifying paranormal activity. Ooh. So, back in 2022, I shared Nick's story on Nuke's Top 5, along with some of the scary footage that he had captured. Last 2 years since those videos were recorded, Nick Perry has moved to a new house in a new city, but he believes that the dark entity has followed him.
I just got home, and as I was walking in, I heard some banging noises in here. So that's why I'm setting up the camera right now to find out, you know, what the it is. Max, shut up. There's nobody here.
It's like a shadow. Did you see that? It's like somebody was there. Moving. Is that furniture? That bookcase
moved. The f***ing wall.
That's weird.
Nick decides to leave several cameras recording when he's away from home. When he reviews his footage, he is shocked.
Aw, Ghost just hungry. Just wants a snack. Gotta do some laundry, maybe? Wow.
Nick says that he's reached out to several churches and religious authorities, but no one has helped him. As of today, Nick says that he continues to experience paranormal events in and around his home. He shares his dark experiences over on his YouTube channel. Mimic. Leandro.
Running up to one of the standing cameras and knocking it over. That's funny. That's a smart ghost. That's a very smart ghost. Very funny. Very funny. The worst part is the writing. Sometimes. Sometimes. I howl, there's something's causing lights to flicker. Yeah. 100%. Dear David, you don't think you say, well, I was joking. It's not actually Dear David. That'd be ridiculous. I just thought it was a funny thing that it's like a little child doll looking thing. That's all. It was funny. But yes, David was only haunting Adam Ellis. Another reason why it probably wasn't real. It's a big UFO. Yeah, it's pretty big. Pretty big. In the film, nope, the revelation came to my conclusion that it's not a UFO, but an actual alien predator that preys on those that look at it. Okay, I can see that. I can see that. He said, fun with it. Don't believe it till I see an alien performing the skelly bones dance. Yeah, that'd be good enough proof for me. I'm with you on that. It's not that hard to fake horror vids. I mean, that's 100%, 100%. I'm not saying all horror vids are faked. I mean, obviously, that'd be crazy that every single one put online were faked. I don't believe that. But, you know, you do have to filter through a lot of the crap. And, I mean, it just comes with the territory, doesn't it? Nice beat. Sicker MK, welcome to the chat. Yo, my dude, how are you? Can blame him? No, we can't blame him. He was the ghost opening the fridge. I feel like I'd do the same. I would totally just be like, what kind of snacks have they got? Like, you hungry, exactly, man. Joaquin Santana, welcome to the chat, my dude. Ghost, yeah, it could be. Although I gotta admit, that one's a little bit more interesting. The fact that it potentially even followed him, that's always interesting. I do think that could be a thing. That's why I think, you know, you want to be careful if you're gonna contact spirits and stuff, because you never know who you're gonna get and if they can follow you. That's my opinion. Even if they're fake, it's still scary to watch. Yeah, well, that's true. But I think that's the point, right? You want to make it believable. Believable scary, because then people will watch it. Totally true, though.
From Buenos Aires, Argentina, says that he began to experience strange, unexplained events only weeks after moving into his new home. He says that he would often discover that many of his belongings had been inexplicably moved into the house's bathroom. What? Leandro installed a security camera to see what's been going on.
My God, do we get to see that?
Late one night, he captures something more than he bargained for.
Is he got a wrestler's belt? Are they going to drag him into the bathroom? That's just such a weird thing. Dragging his stuff into the bathroom? Like, that's so strange. Is he going to see them drag his stuff?
Saucy, quit, fall down.
Okay. It's pretty weird.
Leandro is completely unnerved by the strange paranormal experience. He decides to check into the history of his new home for answers. He is horrified when he discovers that in the 1950s, a family of four passed away in a tragic fire on the very same land where his house now sits.
That sucks.
Another night, and Leandro has his friend Daniel over. And once again, shit goes sideways.
Shit goes sideways. I love it. Is there somebody outside? Yeah, did you see that up there? It looked like there was somebody outside.
A mysterious white figure can be seen passing by the window just outside Leandro's home. Then the item sitting on the nightstand get launched into the air by an invisible force. And Leandro and his friend Daniel jump up in shock. And now, this is when things get really strange. Because Leandro claims that after this incident, the spirit that haunts his house actually began to imitate or mimic the sound of his friend Daniel's voice.
Son las 3 de la mañana de nuevo. Y esto es lo que yo, con lo que yo convivo desde hace meses. Con esto yo convivo hace meses. Siempre que grabo. Vos no sos Daniel. Vos no sos Daniel, esa no es tu voz. Vos no sos Daniel, esa no es tu voz. Daniel se fue hace meses del país. Vos no sos Daniel. Si querés lastimarme, salí y lastimame ahora. Ya. Déjame de joder. Déjame de joder. Yo así no puedo vivir. Ya no puedo vivir así. Ya no puedo vivir. ¿Qué es eso? ¿Qué es eso? Yo no tengo más miedo. No tengo más miedo. Oh, yo así no puedo vivir. Así no puedo seguir.
Leandro says that he's had more than enough of the strange supernatural activity in his new home. But is it real? Or is it all just an elaborate hoax? You decide. Footprints. A woman named Kat lives in a remote area near the woods in Pennsylvania. One freezing cold morning around 4 a.m., Kat wakes up to find a light dusting of snow covering the ground outside.
Always fun.
Then she notices something just outside her back door. Something truly disturbing.
Ooh. Good morning, guys. It is literally 5 a.m. and I opened the back door to put some dry food out for the stray kitties. And there are people feet printed all over my deck in the snow. Do you see this?
Homeless people?
They start over there. And it like barefoot walks up to the table. There's nothing coming up to the... Maybe there is something coming up to the door. What? And I don't see any in the yard. What is this? I see them kind of coming out of the flower bed. They stop there. I thought maybe they would have walked off through that flower bed, but I don't see anything there. It's like one straight line from out in the yard up to the door, turned around towards the table, and then just stopped moving. That one has like 1, 2, 3, 4, like 6 toes. That's 6 toes. So is that one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is 16 degrees out. I have not gone outside yet. My cat came and woke me up. Hysterical, probably because there was some barefoot person on the deck. I'm just more concerned about like a mental health crisis because there's no reason to be out there barefoot.
Now, for obvious reasons, Kat is a bit freaked out, but she's also worried that someone might be experiencing a mental health crisis and is wandering around in the freezing cold with no shoes.
Fair.
She calls the police, but she's reassured that no one has been reported missing or lost. And there have been no reports of trespassers or break-ins in the area.
Could be a homeless person.
Kat is concerned, but she's done all she can, and she just lets it go. But almost 2 weeks later, the mysterious footprints are back.
Okay, morning footprint update. Let me show you. This is the first time we've had snow since the initial footprint sighting. Do you see that? They're barefoot again. They're in a different spot than...
Use some cameras, girl.
Look at my shadow. So those prints are in a different spot than when we had prints before. Let's go downstairs. It is 7 o'clock. I've been up since 4:30. I didn't look outside. I just came up here and then I opened the window to see if any of the stray cats were coming up to the door yet because I didn't feed them yet.
This is fascinating. So this has only recently happened. If it's 4:30 in the morning.
I'm gonna stay right along the side so I don't interfere. Those are definitely very bare human feet, but there are not six toes on these that I can tell. I don't know. Though those are very clear toes right there. So the house next door has nobody living in it, so I'm not sure why the prints would be coming from that deck.
If nobody's living there, there could be a squatter.
Happy New Year.
Kat purchased 2 security cameras to monitor the outside of her home. But the mysterious barefoot stranger hasn't returned yet. So could this be something supernatural? Or is it something even scarier? A real person creeping around Kat's house in the middle of the night.
Yeah, for real.
Heads up.
That's pretty spooky. But then it makes you wonder, how many times before have they walked there? Or is it a shapeshifter? Is it a skinwalker? Hopefully time will tell now that she's got her cameras. Hopefully time will tell. Let's go up the door here. Ghost in the house. Punch. Listen to sleep well. We will. We will eventually. We will qualify. Don't worry. Should have just gave one good punch. Sometimes that's all it takes. Just knock out the shower ghost, man. Knock out the shower ghosts, exactly. We're all agreed, shower ghosts. Horrifying. Something's hitting the shower curtain, even the front door was open. It's pretty spooky. It is spooky. You're totally alright. How do you sleep like that if it's real? Brave? Think it's real? They barefoot. Yeah, people feet. Let me sniff. No, Arlo. No. Yeah, you get put on a list, man. Careful with that. Arlo got some goals. Mental health crisis is a good point. It was a very, very good point. Yeah, 100%. It was good that she was able to check into that. Z says, somehow went to the beginning of the stream, was confused by watching Willy Wonka again. Yeah, no, we're good. We're good on that. Thank you for subscribing. Oh, God. Is that... I don't know how to pronounce... I don't know. What? Vantage? Maybe Vantage? New species, six-toed hobo. 3 weeks ago, you were in the bathroom and you saw a hand waving at you in the shower, so you could see the hand and arm, so you punched the shower curtain, but there was nothing there. Could have been a cat. Could have been a cat. Because cats have hands. Last one.
Popular Chinese ghost hunter Xiao Long is back, this time investigating an abandoned school in China that is said to be extremely haunted. As his livestream audience watches, Xiao Long begins to hear unexplained noises from somewhere in the building. He's a little on edge as he goes to check out the strange sounds. What happens next is... just watch.
That's just funny. That's funny.
Xiao Long gets the fright of his life because of a plastic statue head. But luckily, Xiao Long delivers a good old-fashioned slap upside the head to put that statue back in line. But things are about to get a bit more serious and a bit more frightening. As Xiao Long explores deeper into the haunted school, this happens. Thank you.
ball's rolling. It's pretty weird. I love Asian cultures because some of them are very respectful about, like, you know, trying to get rid of the spirit, and then in some of them you have to swear at them. It's so funny because they'll say things like fuck your mother and things. Yeah, see. You have to be like really mean to the spirit. This is so funny.
A small ball inside a classroom rolls across the floor by itself, so Shaolong chucks it out a window. But then the lights hanging from the ceiling come crashing down, almost hitting Shaolong. Now, luckily, the ghost hunter made it out safe, but he's not done just yet. Inside one of the school's many rooms, he finds a dirty old mirror. And this is when his exploration takes a terrifying turn.
It's hard to make out, but if it was still there, it's fair. It's creepy weird. That's so funny. The Asian ghost hunters are always so fun. Jordan Manny Penny, welcome to the chat, my dude. I love it. It's so creative. Oh god, that's so funny. Is it still there? Can't really tell at the moment. Doesn't look like it. I think he's okay. Face looking through the window? Oh yeah, there's like a little something. This gets so bad. It's so funny. But it's how they're raised to, like, to deal with ghosts. They're meant to be really mean to them.
In the mirror's reflection, someone can be seen standing behind Shaolong. But when he swings around in terror,
oh my god,
there's no one there. After an attempt at kicking and flailing at the invisible entity, Shaolong finds that the reflection of the figure has disappeared. But now he spots a shadowy face peeking in from a window, and a heavy closet comes crashing down right in front of him.
Oh, God.
The activity is becoming a little too intense. So Shaolong decides to leave and ends his live stream. You can see even more terrifying moments from this ghost hunt over on the YouTube channel, Outdoor Shaolong.
Oh, that was like Nuke's top five. Always so funny. Some stuff that's so funny. POV, you were scared of Wabam. Frick you, spooky man. Not afraid of you, said by a very scared man. Yeah, obviously, you know, you got to be mean to him, but you're still scared. We have Jordan Manny Penny now. The bird one is creepy as hell. Ah, you talking about like weird birds? Yeah, yeah. I'm with you. It's pretty creepy weird. Pretty creepy weird. Poor ghost, but he's like, ooh, what the fuck? Think he killed the ghost. He might have done. He came for round two, didn't he? Came for round two with that ghost. Oh god, this is so funny. It's so funny. Oh my god. Okay. Right. What time is it? 7:13? Okay. Okay. I could probably throw another 30 to 45 minutes at the stream. Sounds like a decent time. It depends whether we want to move on to an analog horror or whether we want to keep watching silly ghost things. What are you guys thinking? What are you thinking? You subscribe, Jordan Manny Penny. Thank you, man. Thank you. I appreciate that. I just don't see that on this page. I see it on a different thing. Imagine having a guy come to your house and having your mother insulted. Yeah. Ollie Pearls, welcome to the chat. Silly ghost. You're quite right. Okay. Okay, Kwong. We will listen to Sleepwell right now. How is I'm typing your name. I'm so sorry. Let's do that. CG5. We will do that right now. Let's do that. And then we'll move on to some analog horror. We'll do that. Great. It was fun. It was a good little game. Good call, Kwong. Good call, my dude. It was good. That was very good. Very good indeed. Let's see. Analog horror, so we're looking to do... We could start Basswood County. That's true. That is true. That is true. It's the first thing I've written down today. Basswood County. Yeah, it is by Dark Mind, isn't it? God, it just looks like it's going to be so cool, doesn't it? Let's see. Perfect. Perfect. Ginger Radio, welcome to the chat. Have I seen Vita Carnis? Oh, yes. Oh, yes, I have. I've seen it two or three times now. Man, it's still so good, though. What a brilliant little thing. Ognam, welcome to the chat, my dudes. It does look like it's going to be something. Let's jump in, shall we, boys and girls? Oh, God, I wasn't ready for all that. I'm so sorry. I'm not watching Vita Carnis a third time. I'm not doing that. Okay.
This is a warning from Basswood County Police Department to the residents of Basswood County and neighboring counties. We have received alerts about a humanoid creature that invaded the county. It has been 11 murders till now. The victims' bodies show decapitation, absence of arms and hands due to amputation, stabbing in the neck. It is clear that there is a hostile creature around you and you should do the following. Close your doors and windows. Grab any weapon. Hide in your basement or the attic.
Attic? It's the only problem with robots. Oh god. Why the loud beeps? Sorry, sir. Wait. Could be useful. Tall, long-limbed, long neck, long fingers. An unnatural face, menacing eyes and smiling, short brown hair. So it's an elongated man or woman, I guess? Okay. Like super stretchy. Oh. Why the scanning beeps? Your achievement compared to the creature. Okay, it's taller. Is it salad fingers? That's got a salad fingers vibe.
To make you able to identify this creature, we are going to show you five police sketches that were drawn according to eyewitnesses' descriptions.
So we're seeing eyewitness descriptions. Okay, so he kind of looks like a bit more of a decrepit looking man. Ooh. Yeah, they mentioned smiling, didn't they? That one's not smiling. Pretty horrifying. That doesn't look like the rest of them. That last one looked different. Footage. Ooh, okay. Pennywise action going on down in the sewers. Okay. Well, I guess there he is. You found him. Well done. Location to a victim's home. He's laughing in this dude's house. Pretty creepy. Where is he exactly? Oh, there he is. Okay. Not the most believable arm, but, you know, I'll roll with it. What was found in the victim's basement? Ah, right, okay. You're saying it was seen even ages prior, maybe? Image found beside a disposable camera that belongs to the victim. I mean, it's definitely horrifying, you know. Okay. Okay, I think there's some cool potential here. We'll keep watching. Sorry, let me catch up with you guys. Yep, we another analog horror, Dog Nightmares. Yeah, Dog Nightmares, I quite enjoyed myself. I thought it was pretty good. I think it's still going on as well, so I haven't seen every single one. But it is good. I quite like it. Gives you flashbacks because you get Amber Alerts 2 a.m. Yeah, God, tell me about it, right? Third time the charm. Dog Nightmares, yeah. Me, do you want to take the MLMB test? What's the MLMB test? If you can't. Gemini Home Entertainment is another good analog horror, 100%, 100%. Giovanni's a liar, welcome to the chat, my dude. Ognum says, we could do Mr. Samuel's Tea Time Stories for Confused Adults. Haven't heard of it. It's gonna go on the list. Mr. Samuel's Tea Time Stories for Confused Adults. Interesting. Always good to have something new on the list. Grab a piece of paper and a pencil to take the test. Jordan Manypenny giving me a test like in the chat. That's going to be hard to take. Agree with Ginger Radio on Gemini Home Entertainment. 100%, man. Creator's good at drawing. Yeah, actually, you're right, actually. The drawings are really good. Seeing if you're doing this, terrorist people. Victim dead. Goodness gracious. Thank you, Isaac Garza. Ah, yeah, you mentioned the Doors analog horror. Hang on, I'll write that one down. Doors, not to be confused with the band. Mandela Catalog. Ah, oh, wow, Mandela Catalog. Always a good shout, but I mean, I think it's over now. I think. I don't actually know, but I know I've seen the majority of it. I have to have a look. Because I don't know. I want to say it's done, but I might be thinking of something else. Favorite analog horror? I mean, it's got to be between Local 58 and Gemini. They're so good. They're really, really good. There's definitely quite a few other ones that are really good as well. I mean, Midwest Angelica, I think, is still going on, but that one's got some pretty impressive value production-wise to it. I mean, Mandela Catalog is obviously one of the top ones that, like, I think a lot of people are exposed to, and it's fair enough. That's also really, really good. Detective is next for Basswood. Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, the Detective Jeff Alberson tape. Okay. When are we going to watch More Life of Luxury? Well, we always tend to watch a a little bit of Life of Luxury, but we'll always come back to it because it's always just entertaining. It's always entertaining and enjoyable. How can you not like it, you know? There's a new teaser trailer for the new Mandela catalog. There's a new Mandela. Oh my god, it's too much to keep up with after a point, isn't it? You have a channel, the name Delty Ray 15. Delty Ray 15. I'll write it down. I'll have a look. We'll find out if any of these can be worthy of a Saturday. Luxury Dark, yeah. Not even the best mom analog horror. Oh, there is something about the best mom, isn't it? Oh no, what was the oh god, what was it? Something about somebody's wife or like his caretaker or something. I can't even remember. But she like talks about killing his wife. I don't know. The winner of 83. Oh yeah, Foof. That was a good one. You're right. Anyway, we need to watch more Basswood. We're gonna get too caught up. He found some tapes recorded by the house owner. Okay. The police scanned the tapes and found the recordings of the victim's rooms before the breaking into his house by the anomaly. Okay. Under the supervision of Detective Jeff Alberson, these tapes were named his footage collection, okay, as they were collected by him. Well, I mean, that's... I don't really see why the naming of it is important. The police also found a sketchbook that belongs to the victim. These were the drawings. Okay. Cool. I like that. Yeah, so at least there is a level of consistency as to what this anomaly looks like. So I appreciate that. It's not like billions of versions and stuff. It's just the one anomaly so far. Which is at least easier to keep track of. I like that. Basswood County Police Department. Cool. Midnight in the house in question, where the anomaly breaks in. Okay. 3:15. Well, there he is. The bedroom window. Ooh. And there he is inside one of the rooms. It's not really video footage, though, is it? More like still images of stuff, which is fine. Just say this is all we could recover of the footage. Instead of making it sound like we're gonna get proper video footage.
3 weeks of masquerade.
Okay, that was it. Okay. There's a lot of cool things about this, and there's also some things I'm like, no. Still a couple of tweaks here and there that could have made it just a little bit better. Still pretty good. Oh, right, identity test.
French nobleman, and now it is time for you to change back and return to your provincial university. And if I...
Classic analog horror. identity test.
You will be shown images of human faces to test your recognition of uncanniness in them. We can hear you.
Okay. It's normal. Maybe normal. No, so it's fine. Well, obviously not normal. What does his face look like? Well, we can't tell. Well, both of those look bad, so doesn't really matter. Oh, okay. I will tell you what your mind cannot comprehend. I will tell you what your mind cannot comprehend. Well, then, can we still comprehend it then? Just because you tell us it again doesn't always mean that we will comprehend it or understand it. It's like how we might not be able to see in a higher dimension. It's something we cannot comprehend, which is probably why we cannot see those things. Pretty creepy, okay. See, this is footage where it's an actual video. This is something. Gonna get something behind a curtain? That's pretty creepy. Oof. Ooh, what was that, big fingers? And they censor it. Oh god, I can't even imagine. I mean, both are bad. Both are bad. Visual hazard, we've all been warned. The failure of Jeff Halverson. Oh, the detective. Well, see, this is better. The fact there is actual, like, footage. I like that. That's, it just helps build it, you know? It's staring at you. See you. Okay. Thank you for that. Ooh, there's a shadowy. Oh, it's his hand. Chamber in the woods, where they come from. A door to a realm. We know where you live. What? Something was video recording him? Is that what we were supposed to understand from that? Why is it so zoomed? What? Ooh. Oh, no thank you. Fuck are you? Oh, okay. Is this all still the same one anomaly? I'm a little confused. I'm so confused. I'm so confused at this point. I don't know, man. I don't even know. Oh. I don't need an explanation yet, but if we go through all of them, because I mean, my current understanding is the fact that it is an anomaly in Basswood County specifically that is murdering people. But then we're also getting just a bunch of strange footage, I guess, of maybe like their victims and things like that. It could be just a lot of that. There could be more to it. I haven't quite figured out yet, but maybe I don't have enough information.
How can you live a peaceful life?
Lapeep, welcome to the chat.
Do not care about people's opinions. Get out. Sit in a park, around the trees, where you can watch the sea.
So I guess he's corrupting video footage now, is the anomaly.
Feel the breeze in your skin.
And remember, when you are not running, I'm only getting closer.
Let's see. I wonder if that is him. Maybe he's like morphing in a way. Maybe. Maybe. The chamber. Ah, they mentioned the chamber. Okay. Chamber in the woods. You think that's a great idea? Yeah, I would have thought so too. Seems like a chill dude. An alright guy. Chamber in the woods, where they come from. This is interesting. Mr. Calvin Basswood discovered an odd building in the woods in 1868. Okay, getting some backstory too. Cool. He discovered in it the what now named after him Basswood. In his diary, he said that it looked like something from the future, a building that no one knew it existed. No one knew who built it. He entered the buildings and saw people. They looked like human beings, but something was strange about them. They showed no emotions or response. They had unnatural limbs and tree roots coming from their backs. Yeah, that kind of sucks. They began to show hostile behavior. He escaped the place. Yeah, shit. He called it the chamber. He's got like the Buzz Lightyear chin going on. Oh, God. I will wear your skins as a suit. Oh, well, that's nice. Thank you. Oh, that makes me think of Little Nightmares. That's great. I have to remember when the third chapter's coming out, man. Little Nightmares 3, we're streaming that. That's happening. I think it's October, maybe. I think it's a fair distance away, so. Andy Stevens after the transformation. Oh, okay, so. So, normal people can transform into these creatures as well. Okay. Philadelphia Group. 1996, a group of researchers from Philadelphia, U.S. went to investigate the cases of missing people in only 1 month in Basswood County. They went across the county and Basswood Forest and recorded the journey. This is what they saw. Interesting. Thank you for subscribing, Spoon Son. Son of Spoon. The chamber. It's pretty weird if you found that in 1868. Obviously, it's no longer 1868, but you know what I mean. You know what I mean? Like, it can't have changed, right? Are we going to see maybe some of the... Is that one of the roots that came out? I don't know. Are a lot of roots around it, I guess, because it's to look like they live here, even though it's probably abandoned. Very clever way of story writing that. Why the music, though? They entered the chamber. Location, the chamber, right corner. I guess that's what they saw. It's like his cave was sculpted and his brain was taken out, maybe. Weird. Maybe they feast on certain body parts? Chamber, left zone, entrance from the hallway. television playing a distorted face with a VCR and a tape titled Identity Test. Ah, so they were watching the Identity Test themselves. They were stuck on the wall. I will tell you what your mind cannot comprehend. Yeah. So we saw that in the video. Clock table with human remains and a skull on it. Oh, God, okay. A lot of weird things in the chamber. Corpse of woman with breaks and holes in her body. Her eyes were missing and her mouth with no teeth in it. Her skin was melting like wax. Roots coming from his back. Yeah. Oh my God. The group got out of the chamber. They went to Basswood Forest. I was going to say it's very quiet. I was wrong. Gross. Great. Hi. You're quite tall. Only two members of the group out of seven survived. Sucks, bro. The chamber map. Wow, they were able to map it out? Jeez. That's the entrance side, the left zone, the right zone, and then obviously back into the big area. See, and that's where the entryway is. Okay. But the main hall seems to be where a lot of the main things happen. The window, where they come from. Oh, so that must be how they, like, leave the chamber. Or how they come into our world, maybe? It's like a portal? Creepily on the wall.
What is a human? Hello, I am Doctor. In this tape, I will teach you about the human anatomy. The human is a chamber for them. I will show you how they will control your body.
What?
Here is the human head where consciousness exists. Here are the nerves. That's how the head looks after the creatures use it. These are the small nerves. And here is the core. They create it so they can control your body. Here is the structure of a humanoid brain. The brain of a humanoid is different from the brain of a human's. It okay. functions only to serve one purpose. Let us in. Here are the characteristics of a humanoid. Long limbs, long fingers, tall, roots coming out of its back, can extend their neck, uncanny facial features, no emotions.
Thank you, Demario Page. Stage one, true form. Stage 2. Stage 3. I guess it's getting kind of humanoid. Yeah, so it's like becoming more human. It takes time for them to reform the face to look like a human. To look like you. Chamber. Ooh, more stuff about the chamber. Cool, 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 cool. Oh, no, that's the end of it. I'm with you. With you. Is that? Oh, no, there's still a couple more. Still a couple more. Okay. I thought that was maybe the end of it, but no, we have two more.
All residents of Basswood County must stay alert for a suspected murderer. Close any entrance to your house and grab a firearm.
Whoa! Jesus. Face only a mother could love.
This is the Basswood County. Warning, there's a criminal on the run. But witnesses who lived have said that he is not a normal human being. He runs around at an unusual speed. He is not seen normally by law, and was he starts to kill his prey. Sometimes he toys with them and does not kill them, just leaving them traumatized. And this is the last found footage of the criminal at the moment of his stop, captured by our fairly distant fast CCTV programs.
Why does it do that? Learn to equalize your sounds, people. Even now it's still too loud. Jesus Christ. Aye, aye, aye. Hi. I don't know even if the mother loves that face. You guys crack me up. Wait, did they capture it? Not the best place to hide. You're right. You're right. Oh, you're good. I mean, the fact that pretty much the entire thing is done by the one guy is always admirable, and it's very impressive, you know? I feel like my soul is being dragged into that place. A parasite taking over my mind. Can't sleep anymore. Sorry, I had a burp. I'm going insane.
Welcome to Basswood County's informational tapes. After many reports of lack of sleep, degrading mental health due to insomnia and night terrors, this tape will give you methods to have a healthy sleep and make a spiritual distance between you and the...
Hi. Are you still awake? I mean, you know, I'm awake enough.
Go to bed at an even hour. This means that you go to sleep at 10 p.m., 12 a.m., 2 a.m. and avoid the odd hours as they may put you at risk of the wanderer effect, which makes you sleepwalk.
Okay. I don't think that's a real thing, but okay.
Look at the clock before sleeping. Is it ticking? Is it ticking? Or is it stopped?
Oh, okay. Interesting. It's gonna be the door, right? Oh. Oh, hi. How did you get in here? Yeah? That's cool. Gonna eat my face now? Awesome.
Sweet. Bury your consciousness. Let them in.
That's a cool effect, Pam. Oh, Jesus. What kind of abomination are you, man? before you sleep. And that one was 2 months ago, this one. Man, that's good. That means that he's still working on it. He's still actively putting in his time, his skills and everything. Honestly, I mean, it definitely gets better as it goes on. So you can really see kind of the growth of like his improvements and stuff. It's honestly fantastic. Good, man. Good. That was good to see. That was very good to see. Yeah, I enjoyed that. That was nice. Basswood County. Okay. Okay. That's great, man. That's great. You have to keep an eye. Keep an eye on that. Sorry, guys. I know we've been having some fun chats. I'm sorry. We'll have a little laugh. That's good. That's good. Sirius was making his brother and himself jacket potatoes. Solid. Always a good call, my dude. Always a good call. Kwong would like another song. Play That's Not My Neighbor. Forgotten Baby. That was that thing. And DalTray15 says, check out my channel. Well, what have you done, Dalty Ray? What have you? I know you're high howler, so don't think you're confusing me. Done some FNAF stuff? Okay, my dude. You're only 9. Okay. Hey, you know what? It's all about the journey. You know, and you still got time, you still got youth. It's important. Which one do you want us to watch? Which one do you want us to watch? Do you want us to watch maybe this one? The 2-minute one? Should we watch that? Okay. Give you a go. How about that? Don't you want a hug FNAF? I don't know if you're using copyright music. That's the only problem. I can get a strike about that. It's okay. Don't worry. I can deal with a strike. Strike ain't a problem. Multiple strikes are a problem. But we'll be fine. Don't worry. So you're doing like a little music video with these guys? Is that what's going on? Kind of like two different sides, basically. I see. Okay, man. Well, you know what? I mean, first of all, the fact that you can put up in 1080p is already a good thing. That's quite a big thing that I find not a lot of channels are capable of. So, first of all, you should be proud of that. And that's good. I'd be a little careful of using too much FNAF and Poppy Playtime and everything, because the only problem with using things that already exist out there is that if you ever potentially want to do more with your work, you have to avoid things that already belong to other people, because they can come after you. It's a whole thing. It's quite silly. They don't tend to do much against you unless you become big as well. But it's good for you to pursue your passions. You know, I'm rooting for you, my dude. Good luck out there. Anyway, Kwong, sorry, you wanted us to do a song. That's Not My Neighbor. Is that also CG5? I see hello. It's a game. What, That's Not My Neighbor is a game? Is it a game? Sama Neighbor by Nacho Sama. Is that the one? Oh, it's kind of like a Papers, Please-like thing. Oh, that's cool. Okay. Looks really cool. Okay. And it's a body horror and stuff. Yeah, but I mean, see, it's cutesy, so it's just nothing horrific, so that's okay. Okay, okay. That's definitely something we could add onto the list. That's not my neighbor. I like that. I like that. Doris Snowden. We're not going to lick your left nut. But welcome to the chat anyway. Foof, do I want some lore on Basswood County? Yeah, actually, Foof, if you know a bit more about Basswood County, you can kind of clear my mind a little bit. I think I've got an idea about it, but I feel like if you definitely know more, then it's always good to get more perspectives about things, you know? So that's not my neighbor. So when it comes to gaming, because we don't feel that fully sits on Nate Narrates, that goes more on my second channel, Nate Dog, because earlier today we were playing Helltown and Fears to Fathom. But so we could put That's Not My Neighbor on the list. I know next week we're probably going to do, well, probably even this upcoming week, I mean, I'll probably start doing a bit more gaming because I think, I've always been a gamer kind of all my life. But I'd like to do this because I like the Papers, Please aesthetic about it. That's quite fun. But I know we're going to be doing the number episode 4 of Fears to Fathom. We're also going to be doing, crap, I've forgotten it. Something else. Yeah, I feel like a goof. Granny. We're doing the Granny series. I was told to do that. Going to do those. But that's, like I say, if you're on my channel page and you scroll to the bottom, it'll tell you my second channel. That's where the gaming stuff goes. So we will do that over there, just not right this moment. But it is on my list. Thank you, Kwong. Thank you for that. It's okay. It's okay, Doris. You're allowed to have some jokes. Don't worry, buddy. Don't worry. So basically, from what you can tell, the chamber is like a ship or something, but like 100 years ago, our boy Brasswood found it and stuff, and he probably wrote notes because he found a note in the episode. Yeah, true, true. Arlo beat the Ender Dragon. Well done, my dude. You're reaching the end. I'm proud for you. I'm proud for you. What else is on? A bunch of weird shit. That's the problem, you know? I watch all these other people's things, then before I know it, it floods my crap, too. That's the only problem. I gotta click some of these down. Sorry, Foof. You seems like the creatures come out of your heads and form with your DNA, as we saw with our boy Andy missing his head in the chamber. Okay. I mean, I definitely felt like, you know, there was a transformation thing going on, clearly taking over some people. So that's interesting. Doris is having the time of his life. Or her life. I mean, Doris sounds like a female name, but I wouldn't really know. Serious Summer, thank you for that. I appreciate the extra subscribe. Definitely do some urban exploration for me. Oh, Chernikovsky. You should let us know, my dude. That sounds great, man. Take care, Kwong. Xversity, we're all having a little laugh. That's good. Doris still talking about his nuts, but, you know, that's, guess they must be so small he has to keep bringing them up. Foof has hit 100 subs. Well done, Foof. Well done, my dude. Must be all that spoiled frozen pizza you keep giving out. I don't know. You gotta do something about that. Let me close that. There we go. Why did the chat box? No, not socials. What? For some reason, my chat box isn't appearing. I don't know what's going on with that. Should be. I can see it everywhere else, but I'm not seeing it on the stream at the minute. Very strange. It was working, so I don't know. Clearly, it's just having a struggle. That's okay. Adulterace hit 85. Well done. Well done. Keep clapping. Well, now that you asked me to do it, Doris, I'm not going to. Oh, look, there we go. The chat box is working again. Oh, God. We would do some more, but it's been about 3 hours. I need to go. This has been great fun, guys, as always. So probably Arlo is just, I'm gonna let that one through because he's having the time of his life. I'm so happy for him. But I'm trying to keep you guys up to date. So Nate Narrates, we'll keep doing the watch stuff on Nate Narrates. So next Saturday, we'll definitely do some more watching, which we've got a nice little list now, which is good. We can work with some of that. Obviously, we might do some Woodland National Park. We might do a little bit more spooky things to watch and laugh at and everything. I think that'll be fun. I can actually mark that one off now. That's cool. Commit arson on a daily basis. Well, Xversity, I'm not going to stop you, but I have nothing to do with it. That's all I'm saying. Do I have Roblox? No. No, I don't. I do get asked probably every day, though. And for right now, I'm still going to keep saying no. But who knows? Maybe one day we'll do Roblox. I've already been told two that I need to do, so if we were to do it, I'd start with those. But I really don't want to play Roblox. But we'll see. We'll see. Crap, what else am I thinking? I'm trying to let you know what's going on. So let's see. Monday, I might be doing a stream. I have to see if I can get some confirmation about it, but that would be on the Nate Dog Gaming channel. We might do a bit of Halo. On Thursday, on Nate Narrates, though, Jenny, perfect timing. So on Thursday, on Nate Narrates, this channel, we are going to be doing a live stream of some Dungeons & Dragons. That's going to be new. It's going to be interesting for us to do, a first-time kind of thing. That's going to be great. Jenny's going to be there because she's my girlfriend. She's Space Pants. She's going on the adventure with me. And Josh is going to be our dungeon master. That's going to be a lot of fun. We're gonna see. It's gonna be the start of a journey, and I think it's gonna be cool. I think it's gonna be very good. We're gonna be able to teach people a bit about Dungeons and Dragons too, which would be nice. I think it'll be very fun. Let's see. Next Saturday, we're gonna do obviously another watch stream where we're gonna watch a bit of more analog horror. We'll probably watch more other stuff. I'll probably do a bit more gaming. I'll try anyway. I might do like I did today. I might do some gaming earlier in the day. In which case, we might do That's Not My Neighbor. We might do Granny. I think I kind of said I would do those, so we will do those. Fears to Fathom, stuff like that. Yeah. Sounds like a good time. Thank you all very much for being here. This has been a lot of fun. I've had a great time. I sure hope you have too. And we will see you for whatever stream is up next.